रहा हूँ मैं।
ओके
एंड बी अलाइव।
कूल। हाय गाइस, गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम टू द एपिसोड 5। कैन यू जस्ट प्लीज लेट अस नो इफ द साउंड एंड वीडियो क्वालिटी इज फाइन, देन वी विल गेट इट स्टार्टेड। हाय गाइस, anyone, is the sound quality fine?
Hi guys, how are you doing? Yeah, I think the sound's okay. Go ahead, Weber.
Okay, great. All right, welcome to the 5th episode of Olympics on My Mind, guys. I know it's been much awaited episode. Right from the first session that we did, everyone has been asking us to, you know, do shooting. So like we had mentioned on Twitter also, we've been waiting for the Croatia World Cup to get over. That is how we have decided this particular time, so that we can actually include those results as well in our analysis. But yeah, it's one of the hottest sports that we are looking for in Tokyo, and plenty much to talk about. So yeah, let's see what we have in store. We recently concluded the Croatia World Cup. I'm sure there were a lot of disappointments, a lot of expected results as well. And we'll talk about it later in detail. But what did you make of it, Kapil? What was your first reaction the conclusion of it?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, considering how we were doing in 2019, because Delhi World Cup, you know, the number of people or the number of competitors were too low. So we can't really use Delhi World Cup as a yardstick. But looking at 2019,
yeah, absolutely.
Looking at 2019, obviously, it was a bit of a disappointment. But, you know, if you analyze what I felt was, mainly the disappointment was restricted to 10-meter air rifle. So air rifle ke liye, ka we'll talk about. Jisme maybe we could have had better results. But on the whole, I think it was fine. Because, you know, and I would say, you know, I think saw someone's comment on Twitter that this is like, if this is what a bad World Cup is. Even in a bad World Cup, we had one gold, one silver, one bronze, one fourth place, and like another, I don't know, 8-10 other finalists. So that is still great. And you know, if we get like 3-4 medals at Tokyo, I think most people are going to consider it a success only. So on the whole, it wasn't the 2019 World Cup, but I think it was more about, you know, we couldn't convert the finals. We still got to the finals, but final conversion maybe thoda low tha, jitna pehle hota tha.
I think Rahi pulled it up for us. Like, yeah, there was already so much of chatter around, you know, it's been same again, the disappointment we suffered during Rio and same results, inka pressure aate hi thoda wapas se hone lag jata hai. But somewhat chatter died down after that Rahi's amazing performance. And by the way, what an amazing performance that was. Four straight series of 5 shots. I don't know if I've seen that before ever.
अरे आई तो वोट कुडेंट बिलीव इट यार, आई वाज लाइक अरे ये क्या हो रहा है, मतलब यू जस्ट कांट मिस, मतलब है ना, व्हेन आई थिंक आफ्टर लाइक 22 23 शॉट्स शी गॉट अ फर्स्ट मिस एंड आई एम लाइक ओ अरे यार स्ट्रीक टूट गया. लेकिन इवन इन द एंड, यू नो, आई रिमेंबर इन द वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड मेरे को ऐसा याद था कि शी सॉर्ट ऑफ गॉट टू 30 एट वन पॉइंट टुवर्ड्स द सेकंड हाफ, थोड़े एक 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 मिस होने लग गए थे, बट शी गॉट टू लाइक 30. And at that point, you know, मैं lunch कर रहा था, लेकिन I left it and I don't know, lunch कर रहा था, dinner कर रहा था, मैं कुछ खा रहा था, I left it and you know, I went to my laptop के world record क्या है, and मैंने देखा कि world record
exactly
and you know, I saw okay, world record is 40 and she's at 30, तो okay, like यार अब 10-on-10 मानना है world record के लिए,
it's good possibility,
but it's still tough, right? 10-on-10 मानना है, you have to equal it, and then I suddenly realized, अरे 10 नहीं 15 शॉट बचे हैं, 15 में से 10 मारने हैं टू मैच द वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड. बट या अनफॉर्चुनेटली शी हैड अ लाइक वीक सेकंड लास्ट सीरीज में आई थिंक शी डिड 2-on-5, जिसके वजह से एक पॉइंट से छूट गया वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड. बट या, इट वाज अमेजिंग, इट वाज माइंड ब्लोइंग.
आई थिंक ऑल द मोर अमेजिंग आफ्टर ओवरकमिंग दैट टेक्निकल ग्लिच शी हैड इन द बिगिनिंग. So obviously you're totally zoned in, right? And even the slightest of the disruption can change your focus or can disrupt you. But she came back after that technical glitch and straight away started with such a great shooting.
हाँ लेकिन टेक्निकल ग्लिच में तो ये भी है ना, मतलब आई मीन इट हैज अ हिस्ट्री राइट, अ बिट ऑफ अ हिस्ट्री. वी ऑल नो अबाउट बिंद्रास टेक्निकल ग्लिच राइट. सो अपेरेंटली ही हैड सेड दैट ही बैंक्ड हिज गन समवेयर और मे बी इट वाज अ सैबोटाज एंड हिज गन वाज कंप्लीटली आउट ऑफ साइट जस्ट लाइक बिफोर द फाइनल स्टार्टेड. एंड उसके बाद
या आफ्टर द क्वालिफिकेशंस और ड्यूरिंग द ट्रांजिशन.
जस्ट हाँ सो जस्ट राइट एट द फाइनल. सो फाइनल का साइटिंग टाइम ही वाज फुल्ली जस्ट यू नो चेंजिंग द साइट्स ऑफ हिज गन. ही हैड नथिंग एल्स टू डू बट ही सेड इट मेड हिम मोर फोकस. सो इट कैन वर्क बोथ वेज. बाय द वे
फेयर
तक
इनफ.
वैभव एक ट्वीट मार दे कि वी आर लाइव सो मोर पीपल विल कम. एक बार वी आर लाइव मारते हैं तो लोग आ जाते हैं. एंड
या टिल देन डू यू वांट टू सेट अप द एक्सेल.
Excel is set up. Setup is not an issue.
Excel is set up.
Yeah, Excel is set up. The guys, so the only thing I'll say, this could be a marathon stream. We will go, you know, 10 events one by one by one. So it will take, it can be a pretty long stream. But there is a possibility ki if it's going on too long, then we might split into two parts. So we don't know how it will happen, but just a disclaimer there. So should we jump in? Kya aur kuch bolna hai?
Yeah, I think we should.
Okay, so 10 meter air rifle se start kare. I think because rifle was the one, 10 meter rifle was the one jahan Osijek ya Croatia mein thoda dicey tha. So I say let's go with 10 meter rifle women. Yeah.
I think yeah, women. Let's start with women because it's also one of the most anticipated events for us. Na, everyone has been waiting because of the performances we've had.
Yeah. So guys, this is the file jo we have made. For 10 meter rifle, as you can see, we have considered basically the 7 World Cups.
Couple, it's yet to come on the screen.
हाँ ठीक है वो आ जाएगी टेंशन मत ले. So we have considered you know the 7 World Cups. मतलब World Championship एक 2018 का, which is when the shooting qualification cycle started. So which is when you know people really start coming in. And after the World Championship, you had 4 World Cups in 2019. Delhi, Beijing, Munich and Rio. And then 2020 mein kuch nahi hua. So then we had the 2 World Cups in 2021. One was Delhi, which had honestly very low participation. And we had Osijek, jo abhi bhi khatam hua. So if you look at the slide, upar jo blue mein dikh raha hai, I have just put that ke how many participants were there in every World Cup. So chat mein cricket hi chal raha hai. Cricket versus guys, cricket अपना sport है, shooting अपना sport है. You can't really blame cricket for the other things. Cricket doesn't take any.
But anyways, why bring cricket and shooting?
नहीं वो general concept है ना कि cricket दूसरे sports का पैसा खा जाता है और दूसरे sports you know are down on cricket. Yeah. So anyway, so we'll take that topic someday some other time. Anyway, so yeah. So I was saying जो ऊपर blue में दिखा रखा है, that are the number of participants in every World Cup. And you know one thing which I found interesting across the events, okay, Munich World Cup also has you know a lot more competitors than the World Championship. So if you look at here, World Championship mein sirf 113 rifle mein the, women rifle mein, and Munich had 149. So I mean it's not even like a small gap. 36.
That's not surprising, right? Because Munich, by some people, it is considered as the mecca of shooting World Cup, so to say. That this is one shooting World Cup hardly a shooter would want to skip in their schedule.
Exactly. So Munich is and I think another factor is you know it's in Europe. So wo bhi thoda factor hota hai because you know a lot of the shooters are based in Europe. It's much easier for them to you know show up in Munich or to show up in Europe. Jaise World Championship was in Korea this time. World Championship I think agar Europe mein kahin hua tha to maybe the competitors would have been more. Lekin is baar Korea mein tha. To us hisab se bhi hai. ठीक है सो लेट्स जस्ट गेट इन टू दी एनालिसिस. सो एनालिसिस में या यू कैन सी आई हैव टेकन द नंबर ऑफ वर्ल्ड कप नंबर ऑफ इवेंट्स आउट ऑफ दी 7 प्लेड बाय एवरीवन. सो दिस इज मेन इज यू नो हाउ मच दे कम्पीटेड इन द मेन इवेंट एंड उसके अलावा एडिशनल हाउ मच दे कम्पीटेड इन द MQS. सो MQS फॉर दोज हु डोंट नो MQS इज लाइक what do we say like
minimum qualifications.
Yeah, so MQS means minimum qualification score, but the MQS event is like a you can say a side event. So it's like every country is allowed to send 3 shooters to a World Cup, but they in addition to the 3 they can also send 2 more shooters in the MQS category who just go there and who shoot qualification and whose scores are valid for you know world records and for their own personal scores and own personal records and everything, but their scores are not valid to get them into the final. So that's an MQS category. And उस हिसाब से यू नो एवरी कंट्री कैन हैव अ मैक्सिमम ऑफ 5 शूटर्स एवरी वर्ल्ड कप. इंडिया ने फॉर एग्जांपल
इट्स लाइक इफ यू आर एबल टू स्कोर MQS यू बिकम एलिजिबल टू शूट इन ओलंपिक्स.
एग्जैक्टली दैट्स द मीनिंग ऑफ MQS. लेकिन ऑनेस्टली MQS अचीव करना फॉर द टॉप शूटर्स इज लाइक जस्ट अ फॉर्मेलिटी.
But yeah, it's a formality.
So it's there for that that purpose, but people use it for other reasons as well. जैसे for example इंडिया ने क्या किया था कि once we have let's say one shooter qualified. So for example let's say Saurabh Chaudhary qualifies in 10 meter pistol. So once Saurabh Chaudhary is qualified, we still have to earn one more quota in 10 meter pistol. So then next World Cup, Saurabh Chaudhary will not be competing in the main competition, and three other shooters will be competing. So two has to maximize our chances. And Saurabh Chaudhary, so that he still gets his experience of competing in the World Cup, he will compete in an MQS. So in that way, he is not eligible to the final, but he still gets to go and he still gets to shoot. So that is the impact of MQS. And then this max and min basically shows you the range, as to the range which the shooters have shot across the 7 World Cups. So it gives you as to what you know people can do on a good day and what people can do on a bad day. And then of course we have our averages. You have your qualification average. You have your final average. That is if you shoot a full final up to the gold or silver medal position, this would be your average score. And then per shot averages. And if you see these zeros, these are because these people did not shoot a final. So actually, ye list mein, if you see there is three Nisha Kanwar, Shreya Agarwal, Geeta Bhas, three shooters here were basically like, you know, not shot much. They have all just shot just one MQS score. So ek aadhe World Cup mein MQS shoot kar liya, to jiske wajah se average high ho gaya, but it doesn't really count much. So iske dekh ke, you know, if you look at
Kapil, do you want to speak on country quota? Like what does plus 2 mean? What does 1 plus 1 mean?
Yeah, I missed this. So country quota is basically the number of quotas earned in this event. 2 means, for example, China has earned 2 quotas in air rifle women. And 1 plus 1, what it means is, ke Russia, for example, they have earned 1 quota in 10 meter air rifle. But at the same time, they also have 1 quota in the 50 meter rifle 3 positions. So that 50 meter rifle 3 position shooter, if she wants, she can shoot in the 10 meter air rifle as well. So not generally 50 meter se 10 meter pe to log shoot kar hi lete, ulta may not be happen. So 10 meter guy might 10 meter guy or gal might not shoot in 50 meters or 25 meters. Jaise Saurabh and Abhishek don't really shoot in 25 meters, but Sanjeev Rajput, for example, agar India ke paas 10 meter quota nahi hota, to Sanjeev Rajput or Aishwarya Tomar would have shot in 10 meters. But since we have 2 quotas, it's fine. And similarly, you know, this plus 2, for example, this indicates के 10 मीटर में तो कोई कोटा नहीं है, बट देर आर टू कोटर्स इन 50 मीटर राइफल, सो बोथ दो शूटर्स कैन शूट हियर. एंड सिमिलरली फॉर प्लस 1, 10 मीटर में नो कोटास, बट यू हैव वन कोटा इन 50 मीटर राइफल, सो दैट वन शूटर कैन शूट हियर. एंड जस्ट बिकॉज यहाँ पे कोटा नहीं है, दैट डजंट मीन के द शूटर इज वीक, बिकॉज देर आर सम शूटर्स हु आर स्ट्रॉन्ग इन बोथ 10 मीटर एंड 50 मीटर, एंड सो इवेंचुअली दे कैन यू नो शूट इन ओनली विन कोटा इन ओनली वन लिस्ट इन वन.
I think so the list is pretty scattered right now. Do you want to eliminate all the zeros from the main?
Yeah.
Let's just filter them out, right?
Yeah, so we can do something like that. So data filter karke, let's say kya karna hai, I think main event jisme zero hai wo to main hata deta hu, right?
Main zero hata dete hain, later on we might need to remove the ones as well. So as to see ki haan, because even a one would skew some of the averages. Kisi ne on their day they just came and shot 630, so there goes your average as 630, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Wo bhi dekh lenge.
Haan, so wo bhi dekh sakte. So dheere dheere, I mean, we can have a look at this. Yeah, if you look at this list, you know, guys, the averages, you know, have kind of gone down a lot. 11-0 ka, I think. 11-0 dala to tha maine, kuch gadbad ho gaya kya?
Nahi, Ila is there.
There?
She's
actually pretty low. She's there, but she's low.
She's there in my list.
Yeah, she's there.
Okay.
Yeah, so 11-0 is there. 11-0, guys, the average is low. So if you see, her qualification average is 627. And the others have a higher qualification average, India maybe. The reason is, you know, 11-0 started slow. इन द इनिशियल यू नो लेट्स से वर्ल्ड इनिशियली तो थी भी नहीं, मेहुली घोष भी थी, बट इवेंचुअली शी शॉट फुल 6 इवेंट्स. तो वर्ल्ड चैंपियनशिप में नहीं थी, नहीं इनफैक्ट हाँ वर्ल्ड चैंपियनशिप में शी वॉज शूटिंग इन द जूनियर्स, दैट्स वाई शी वॉज नॉट देयर. एंड उसके बाद ऑल द सिक्स इवेंट शी हैज शॉट
आल्सो आल्सो बिकॉज़ हर एवरेजेस वाज डन बाय अ 621 दैट शी शॉट नो
एग्जैक्टली
उससे काफी उसका एवरेज बेकार हो
हां सो एग्जैक्टली सो इसके वजह से भी यू नो एवरेज बहुत नीचे आ गया सो शी इज ऑनेस्टली बीन यू नो अ बिट ऑफ एन इनकंसिस्टेंट शूटर इट्स नॉट लाइक शी इज एट द टॉप ऑफ द लिस्ट थोड़ा अप एंड डाउन हुआ है शी स्टार्टेड ऑफ स्लो इन यू नो दिल्ली एंड बीजिंग वेयर शी हैड सम लोअर स्कोर्स देन म्यूनिक एंड रियो शी डिड वेरी वेल शी गॉट टू द फाइनल एक फोर्थ है गोल्ड है and then Delhi may be no ki na even in a weak field she didn't get to the final Osijek maybe she didn't get to the final so she's coming lekin ha average wise she is low but it's been a bit of an up and down which is not that surprising for the young shooter as well you know learning the craft and uske alawa if you
look at this one peculiar thing you notice about Ela obviously we can discuss it in detail later on also like she is one of the very rare shooters who has a better average per shot in finals than qualification. And typically we consider that, okay, qualifications, you have your own time. You have your own, you know, for each shot, you can take as much as time you want. Obviously, there's a stipulated time for the entire qualification. But typically, for most of the shooters, their qualification scores are higher than final. But Ela, it's actually reverse, which ultimately goes and shows how good a final shooter she is.
Yeah. Sanchit in the chat is saying ke averages have no particular role on the day in shooting. That is correct, guys. Even Virat Kohli can have the highest average, but eventually, you know, he can go get out for the duck on a particular day. So,
yeah.
Eventually,
but then like, we also have to have a parameter to kind of relatively measure them against each other, no? So that's why the averages.
So I mean, I actually think this is pretty similar to, you know, batting in cricket. Kohli can have the highest average, Tendulkar can have the highest average, but eventually on the World Cup final day, they can still get out for the duck. So that is pretty much it. But eventually, you know, you assume that since they are better players, they have a better chance on doing well on the big day. So that's how you do. And at least in shooting, you don't really have an analysis of okay, let's analyze his previous sub Olympics mein kya kiya hai because everybody has like one or two Olympics, maybe three Olympics in their career. Generally, usse zyada hota nahi hai. So you don't have an analysis base there. So, uske hisab se, you know, that's how it works. So obviously, whatever this means, we are trying to figure out who's done well and who's not done well. But yeah, all this might come to absolute naught on the Olympic day. We have no idea about that. And and uske alawa ha the continental championships we have not considered so I think 11L actually also did a little bit well in continental championships so jaise Varun in the chat is saying ke she shot a 630 in the European championships where she was shooting in the MQS
yeah that was a MQS
she also did well in the World Cup final in 2019 wo bhi maine nahi liya because it's a restricted event
nahi
liya so there are a couple of events where she shot well which is not just doesn't happen to be a part of this analysis but yeah She's always been a you know bit of an up and down, and Diggy is saying that you know it's always that final is easy to negotiate as compared to the qualification because you know tough to get into the final out of 60 world class shooters. It's a valid point. Final may be eventually 8-3 करना होता है. मुझे हमेशा लगता है both have their own merits. You know both are tough. In fact. I would say World Cup mein maybe, you know, the final is slightly easier from that perspective because World Cup has more competitors and, you know, even the top nations get to enter all the, you know, three shooters per the category. So it's not like as if just number jada hai, lekin all the best are there in the Olympics. Wo wali bhi baat nahi hai. Olympics mein eventually har country ke do hi hote hain, jabki World Cup mein teen hote hain. So from that...
Also, there's a time factor which can be taken into consideration, no? So, like, there are certain shooters who are good at shooting in finals because maybe they are fast enough or they shoot at an appropriate time. But for qualification, it's you can just go on your pace.
So, it's basically the natural ability of the shooter as well, right? Natural tendency. Can he shoot on demand? Matlab, final, mein basically, you're like 50 seconds, tumko wahi pe shoot karna hai. Qualification mein you can take your time, aaram se shoot karo. Some I've even seen, you know, some shooters they'll basically just go and sit for like, you know, 5 minutes. Agar ek do shot kharab gaye, so they'll get out of their position, maybe take a chair, and then uske baad karenge. The coach can come in qualification. Bahut baar coach hai na bolta hai, shooter ko hai na indicate karta hai ki come, I have to tell you something. So the shooter leaves his position, comes to the coach, then goes back. So all that, you know, you can do that in qualification. You can't do in the final.
And final is totally on command.
Yeah. तो उसमें थोड़ा फर्क पड़ता है Another comment I had seen was, why was Mehuli Ghosh not selected? All based on trials, guys. In trials, there is these three have done well. NRI had a full detailed selection criteria as to how they will be selected. It got messed up due to COVID, honestly, because COVID ke pehle pura defined tha, lekin COVID ke pehle phir then it became a question mark as to how much do you want to focus on the recent form and how much do you want to go by the rules. So eventually they've had a selection committee and they've done something. But in terms of Mehuli Ghosh, primary reason was that she didn't do too well in the trials. And if you look at even Mehuli Ghosh yahan pe bhi, so there's like, you know, this 622.8 bhi hai, but 632 bhi hai. It's been up and down. And she mainly shot in MQS, jahan pe thoda pressure kam hota hai. So wo wali bhi baat hai. But averages wise, she's done well. She's not done badly.
Yeah. With Mehuli, it's like she hasn't been shooting badly, but there have been other shooters shooting better than her.
Exactly. And uske alawa,
Kapil, what are your initial thoughts about this entire, like, if you have any main takeaways from this entire thing?
Yeah, so my main takeaways are, obviously, you know, if you look at this list, it's dominated by China, right at top, okay? Iranians, meko yaad hai, you know, even Weber, if you remember, Rio ke pehle bhi, you know, just as the Olympics were coming close, Iranians had started doing very well.
Are you talking about the two Iranian girls who shot gold and silver in Asian Games? Khedmati and Ilale Ahmadi.
Yeah, and especially I think as you came, matlab Asian Games mein to they shot only, but even in Rio, you know, just as we were coming close to Rio, towards the end, jo Asian Championship mein qualification hua tha, for example, jo Delhi mein hua tha, where we both were there, both were watching live. Wahan pe bhi the Iranians had done very well. And is baar bhi they have come up. तो इरेनियंस का ये ऑलमोस्ट होता है, ऑलवेज होता है, थोड़ा कि लास्ट टाइम भी था, इस बार भी था, दे हैव स्टार्टेड शूटिंग वेल, एंड यू नो इफ यू यू कांट काउंट देम आउट. सो वी हैव दिस फातिमे करमजादे राइट ऑन टॉप, शी हैज शॉट इन थ्री इवेंट्स,
अ लॉट ऑफ इरानियन शूटर्स कमिंग अप.
हां, सो शी हैज शॉट इन थ्री इवेंट्स, ऐसा नहीं है कि यू नो इवेंट कम है, शी शॉट इन थ्री इवेंट्स, शी आल्सो हैज अ 626.9 व्हिच इज लाइक वीक, बट 633 इज एन इनक्रेडिबल स्कोर एंड व्हिच हैज गॉट हर यू नो सिटिंग क्लोज टू द टॉप ऑफ द एवरेजेस. And Chinese तो भरे में, by the way, I have कि China से कौन जा रहा है, तो China से 10 meter air rifle में, we have Yang की, हाँ,
let me just post it in the comment, so that everyone knows, yeah, go on,
हाँ, Wang Qian, and किधर गया, अरे 10, हाँ, Yang Qian,
Wang Lu Yao,
yeah, so, if you see, Wang Lu Yao is on 10, यांग किया तो कहाँ है भी क्या, आई एम नॉट टू श्योर, देखते हैं भी क्या, बिकॉज चाइना बाय द वे वेबर यू नो लिटिल बिट अबाउट चाइना राइट, दे वेंट अबाउट फुल ट्रायल्स एंड एवरीथिंग, यू वांट टू टॉक अबाउट हाउ दे,
ओ या 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 एब्सोल्युटली, सो चाइनीज हैव सिलेक्टेड देयर शूटर्स एंटायरली बेस्ड ऑन द ट्रायल सिस्टम, दे हैव हैड फोर ट्रायल इवेंट्स एंड व्हाट दे हैव डन इज दे हैव हैड अ प्रीटी इंटरेस्टिंग, आई मीन डोंट नो द एग्जैक्ट मेथडोलॉजी दैट दे हैव यूज्ड, बट for every medal and every qualification score they have a point system, and as you go on and you know enter the final or win a medal out of the that trial, you score a certain points. So after the entire four trial systems have been completed, they'll tally your points, and whoever has the two best total points are selected for the Olympics. That's their basic criteria of selecting the Olympics team. No world championship points, medals considered, no world cups, no Asian games, no Asian championship, nothing. Only and only based on trials. But I think for China, they can afford to do it considering their depth in the field. I mean, not sure if other countries can afford to do it. So they do consider the performances of world cups as well. But for China, even their 10th best shooter at any point of time can come up and win a medal in Olympics or any World Cup.
But don't you think India is getting to that level now? Ki hum log kar sakte hain, if you look
India
at...
is for sure. I mean, we might have a similar scenario come Paris, right? The way things are going for us, especially in this rifle and pistol events.
But by the way, I don't know if China, you know, did it specifically this time because, you know, Corona ho gaya. So that Corona, COVID is a huge problem because now, you know, your World Cup performances are in 2019 And you know, we have basically all had a life-changing year in 2020, right? Let's be honest. Your life in 2019 is very different from your life today. So we essentially had, you know, not just 1 year, but a year which felt like 10 years in between. So uske baad, you know, they decided ke all past performance don't matter. Hum log bahut sare competition karenge. Whoever is shooting the best will go. Which, and India, you know, got a little confused there. Ke usme kya karna hai. So they tried to do, you know, some sort of central path, which I guess is fine. It's not a problem. We still have to talk about Apurvi Chandela. That is the big story here. Uske alawa it's fine. And yeah, just talking about China. So
Kapil, can you remove the China filter once?
So I just wanted to say. So talking about China. So if you see Yang Qian, who's the second shooter going to air rifle for China, she has shot like, you know, just a total of one World Cup, and it was pretty weak. 626.5, but she did well in the trials, and that is that. She's going, nothing doing.
Yeah,
and
like Diggy also keeps on talking about very often, right? Shooting is a fickle sport. Things change at the speed of like they change very rapidly.
Yeah, I mean, we ourselves have examples, right? Ranjan Sodhi.
Plenty of examples.
Ranjan Sodhi tha 2012 mein, we all thought he was a big medal hope. He had a problem towards the end where he missed a few shots and not only missed out the final. And we thought, okay, first Olympics hai, Rio mein, you know, he'll come back much stronger. But it didn't work out for him that way. Jitu Rai, another case, absolute monster going into Rio. And by 2018 was overtaken by Saurabh and Abhishek. And even a few other shooters, in fact. So that's how things work.
Yeah.
And there was a comment in the chat I saw that Fateme Karimzadeh is not going for 10-meter rifle, which is correct. I just checked on, at least based on Wikipedia, they are basically sending their two quota holders only. So Khedmati, which you are talking about, is going. So Najme Khedmati and Amina Sadigan. These are the two who are going. And Amina maybe not so strong.
So, Khedmati, I think, participates in 53P as well. So, even that might be taken into consideration.
If you see, you know, Khedmati and Sadegan have basically been their consistent shooters, right? Matlab, they have both, like, competed in five events. Karimzadeh is a little new. She had, like, one good World Cup. 633.6 shoot kiya, but they have maybe announced their team earlier or whatever. So, they haven't changed on that basis. So, ye sab, shooting mein, all this is there only. And yeah, overall, if you look at this, China is there. Korea humne nahi dekha. Do you want to have a look at Korea? Korea jada averages mein toh nahi dikh raha. Korea is a little low in averages. But let's have a look. Korea ka kya haal
hai? And if you'd remember, Kapil, so 2018 World Championship, the gold and the bronze from this event went to nobody but Korea.
Yes.
So there were just two. It was split between India and Korea. We had Apurvi and Anjum, and then I think I.M. Hana was the Korean that won the gold.
Correct.
And then bronze was also won by certain Korea only, and they are nowhere in the picture among top shooters as well. So
top shooters
goes on to show the vastness of the field that 10-meter air rifle women is. Like if you'll filter out these Korean girls for once and see the and scroll down below, you'll see the medal distribution is still 70s or the 80s, which is quite crazy. So on a given day, there are some 70-80 shooters which are capable of, you know, going for a medal.
Yeah, so we have
that intensive competition it is.
Yeah, so we have it on the screen only. So Onya Jung won the bronze in the World Championship. Shot 630. I am Hana shot 630. But uske baad they have been weak. So it's like not, you know, only Indians nahi gira. I am Hana, she has a low score of 621.1. And she's actually shot only two events.
Yeah.
So ek World Championship and she shot one more event after that. And she was very weak in that, 621. And Onhai Jung also, 626 is not going to get you to a final. And, you know, they have also distributed. Korea ke bhi events distributed. Do we have ke Korea ka क्या सिचुएशन है, who's going? Yeah, so कोरिया के,
not sure.
हाँ, so at least based on Wikipedia, कोरिया का चेंज हो गया है, so Kwon Yunji and Park Hee-moon are the ones were going. So that's number six.
First and the last one.
Yeah, first and the last one. So Park Himun, to matlab theek hai, ek event shoot kiya, must be very old event. It doesn't count. So again, based on trials, right? They would have selected Park Himun based on trials only. And Kwon Hin.
Yeah, could be.
And even Kwon Yoon Ji, matlab she's number six. Like in ek event shoot kiya. She shot only the Beijing World Cup, jisme she won the silver. So Korea ka bhi, I think it pretty much, you know, trial based hai, similar to China. And I saw a question in the chat, you know, ki from Lakshya Agarwal, that China and Korea not participating in 2021, will it affect their performance? I don't think so, Lakshya, because from what we have been hearing, as Webber had explained, they are doing a lot of simulations. They have a good 40-50 shooters in India, both countries, and they have been having internal competitions regularly. So it's not like, you know, they are going to be short of match practice. Or World Cup mein dekhe to, I mean, theek hai, Delhi World Cup to yaar hardly kuch tha. It's like, we have rifle mein to phir bhi, you know, 48 competitors the, rifle women mein. You will see other events jahan pe 20-20, 15-15 competitors hai. And China and Korea khud ka shoot kar rahe hai, which is, you know, probably a much better idea. So we'll see how it goes. Yeah. But I don't think, you know, unka preparation kuch weak hai. Preparation is as good as anything. उसके अलावा सो वी हैव टॉक चाइना, वी हैव टॉक इंडिया. इंडिया में हाँ, अपूर्वी चंदेला, आई मीन दिस गाइज इज द इनक्रेडिबल रिकॉर्ड विच शी हैड इन 2019. फोर कंसेक्यूटिव फाइनल्स, जस्ट नैरोली मिस द मेडल्स इन दीज टू केसेस, दो गोल्ड. ओके, एंड शी हैज शॉट वेरी वीक इन द दीज टू लास्ट टू इवेंट्स, दिल्ली एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया. But still, her average is, you know, number 15, which is not bad at all. And basically, I checked, if you remove these last two events, she would have been at the top. So she would have been at the top, tied with Zhao Duzhu at 629.7. But Apurvi is over five events. Okay, Zhao ke bhi char events hai, so not that bad. But yeah, so Apurvi would
have... Because there was this patch wherein Apurvi was on a run, right? And she was scoring nothing but below 629 or 630, and then she's a good final shooter as well. But the thing is, what the major concern about Apurvi is, if you see what she has done over the last 1.5 years, the highest score she's had in that last one and a half years is 625 Kapil. Like, she hasn't been able to beat trials, beat the recent two World Cups. She's not going even beyond 625, which is quite crazy.
And you know, that's,
I mean, not saying she can still prepare and, you know, peak come the Tokyo Olympics, but right now her level is nowhere near to what she used to shoot.
Yeah, so I mean, the way I see it, she's a different shooter at the moment. Hopefully she can get to 2019 levels. But it's not, and also it's not just two World Cups. I say, just as Webber said, we have, you know, had like about four domestic trials as well. Heavily contested domestic trials, and even there, you know,
in this particular year,
in this year, so at the beginning of 2021, and even in those domestic trials, you know, with just Indian shooting, she has ended up, you know, like 30th, 35th, that below. So it's like her performance has really fallen off a cliff. There was a story about, you know, a jacket brand and those things were there, but you don't really know.
But not being able to adjust it easily.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, guys, I'm not too sure how much of that is genuine and how much of that is, you know, trying to explain away why the fall has happened and, you know, trying to get into the team. But it was because of this, you know, massive drop in form by Apurvi that this 10-meter air rifle selection got interesting. Otherwise, pehle it was always between ki, okay, between Anjum and Nila, Apurvi was a lock. Apurvi jaani hi wali thi. And I was predicting Apurvi as India's biggest hope for a female Olympic champion. So we have never had a female Olympic champion.
Yeah.
Other than Manu Bhakar as a team. So Saurabh and Manu Bhakar as a team. So wo doubles mein, it's a debatable whether you call it an individual Olympic champion or not. But in a purely individual event, I was definitely picking Apurvi as our best hope.
That's a pre-pandemic assessment you're talking about,
exactly,
right?
Exactly. Pre-pandemic assessment. So going into 2020, so 2020 before COVID hit, I definitely thought Apurvi would has the best chance of getting the gold for us from the females. But and I don't
it's a similar story for Anjum as well. So even she hasn't shot beyond 625 over last 1.5 years.
लेकिन अंजुम का इतना बड़ा ड्रॉप नहीं है, because you know both things are there. अंजुम का 2019 performance was also not as high as Apurvi, and then अंजुम का 2021 performance is also not as low as Apurvi. So the gap is bigger. So it's like जैसे अगर अंजुम यहाँ से यहाँ गिरी है, तो Apurvi यहाँ से यहाँ गिरी है. That is the point. So and yeah.
But yeah, for someone who has medaled twice in 2019, so then in that case that's a big drop, right?
Once.
I think in terms of selection.
नहीं 2019 में तो मेडल है ही नहीं. If you're talking about World Cup, are you talking about Asians and all that?
I mean not 2019, but Anjum, I think she did. It's a silver in 2018 it came.
हाँ, so silver was the 2018 World Championship. उसके बाद
yeah.
उसके बाद ये she has got to the you know चार World Cup अगर देखेंगे, let's leave this Delhi out. So out of these four World Cups, she has got to two finals. ऐसा नहीं है कि you know she was very weak or she fell off or whatever. And you know there was a lot of, once as Ila started coming up, there was a lot of you know talk even on 2019 के अंजुम की जगह Ila को भेजो. But it wasn't like you know Anjum was weak. She got to two finals.
Yeah, she hasn't had a very high ceiling as compared to other people. That's what you mean.
And she's not, and she's not had good finals after the 2018 World Championship. She's not had good finals. So I mean, teen jagah, you know, this is now three finals where she's gotten, but she's not been able to medal. What she has done very well in the meantime is she kept doing well in mixed team. Mixed team mein she actually has two golds in 2019. So wo waise chalta tha. And then Ila sort of, you know, came up towards the end. Ila bhi, matlab, wasn't really a big force in the beginning. She started coming up, you know, Munich and...
She, I think she shot a 632 in Munich. Didn't get registered a lot because she finished fourth and then Apurvi went on and won the gold. But that 632 started the journey for Ila, I think.
Exactly. And by the way, again, just to remind, okay, this is the Munich World Cup we are talking about. As we talked at the beginning of the stream, Munich World Cup is in a class of its own. When you just compare the number of competitors. So, Munich World Cup, mein, we did so well. But, theek hai. It is it. And
For Ila, I think I just like to add here. So, yes, she didn't have a great performance in Croatia World Cup. But I think if you see, even previous to that, how she's performed in trials. Even in the trials, in the four trials, she was able to shoot 630s in three of those trials. And even in Croatia World Cup, there were some glimpses of her when she was, you know, I think in the mixed event, she was shooting pretty well. And then in the qualification also, she did a couple of rounds which were above 105.5 or something. So honestly, I wasn't too concerned with her. And I still feel she's in a great form. And yes, of course, like I spoke about her earlier, she's a good final shooter and she has a higher ceiling as well. Like she's touched upon 633s, 632s more frequently than any other shooter, not just in India, but if you compare at a global level also, not many shooters have shot above 630s as much as she has done.
Yeah, I think Ila is that one of those shooters, you know, been a little bit too much of up and down. Just give me a second. Ila का basically ठीक है, शुरू में तो obviously she was still young, she was coming up, then she got to this you know Munich Rio level and she was really not looking back after this. फिर 2021 के trials में she did even better, 633, 634, and where she actually faltered was the two World Cups, which is Delhi and Osijek.
Delhi, yeah.
Yeah, those are pretty much the only two places where she has faltered since she started going very well. So there is that hope, but at the same time, you know, wo problem bhi hai ke faltering is a chance. It's not like it's not possible. So thoda up and down hai. But yeah, I think at this point, if Apurvi can somehow rediscover the form, that's a different thing. But at this point, I think Ilavanil is our best chance in this event, right? What do you say?
Do you remember what form was Apurvi and Anjum coming in before World Championship? Do you remember that? Because I feel if they were able to peak for World Championship, which they did very aptly. So, and before that, again, if they were not shooting high scores, so that still gives you a glimmer of hope, right? That maybe it is the preparation that they do before the main event. That is where the major work gets done.
Yeah, so I mean, from what I remember, the
none of. Let me just check if they made to the Asian Games finals or not.
I think Apurvi was doing well, but Anjum definitely had come out of the blue a little bit. And third shooter, I think we on the World Championship was Mehuli Ghosh, jahan tak mujhe yaad hai. Because Ilavanil was shooting in the juniors. That I remember. But I'm not too sure whether shooting in the juniors was a choice or it was a selection. Because I definitely remember that Saurabh Chaudhary had qualified to shoot in the World Championship. But he and his coaches, or maybe more so his coaches, decided that it's better to make him shoot in the juniors rather than in the seniors. So Apurvi definitely had decent form coming in. I think pretty good as well. But Anjum definitely
so was. Apparently, as I can see in the Asian Games, which were like 15 days before the World Championship, Apurvi did actually 629.4, which is great. She finished second in qualification. And the second shooter that went represented India was 11-0 again. Right. And again, it was 620. Like, she faltered there as well.
Exactly.
But yeah, no Anjum in the squad.
So, but that is the thing. So, 11-0, you know, because the selection was based on the same scores, Asian Games was not considered for World Championship selection. So, selection ke hisab se, 11-0 shot in the World Championship, World Championship as well. But the coaches decided to field her in the junior event. So, and junior and senior events were clashing, so you could not have both. So, she contested in the juniors and then Mehuli and Anjum shot in the senior event. And yeah, Anjum definitely came out of the blue. And again, I had seen a question in the chat about Anjum 3 position from Vasant Kumar. So at that point, Anjum was really, you know, seen as more of a 50-meter 3 position shooter as opposed to an air rifle shooter. But I think things started to change for her after this World Cup. And I think even if you look at the score, so we can talk about that when we come to the 50-meter event. But even in terms of score, she's definitely done better than 10-meter rifle now as compared to 50 meters. And uske alawa Weber, so what do you think about this split team selection? Matlab mujhe thoda weird hi lagta hai ki Anjum will be shooting the mixed team but Apurvi will be shooting the women's event, individual event.
I think mere hisab se, like if I talk about from a financial sense, so they've kind of diversified the risk, which makes sense for me because main nahi chahta tha ki, let's say Anjum is selected for both. Right, and she's not entering Tokyo with a great form. So then you, obviously, all the three events get impacted because Anjum is not entering with a great form. And then now you have Apurvi as well. Guys, I'm just talking hypothetically here. But if you have a certain Apurvi as well, which is the third shooter in the mix, so it still gives you one more chance, right? At least that's what my perspective is. What do you think?
Yeah, so... Okay, just before responding to that, I'll just say there are a couple of comments from Diggy in the chat. Apurvi training score yesterday and day before was 629.3 and 629. And
which is encouraging.
Yeah, which is great. But obviously, training and competition mein thoda difference hota hai. But yeah, if she can, you know, get that in competition, that is definitely a final score. And if she gets her form back, you know, she's... You can't underestimate her or you can't discount her. Ek baar form mein aa gayi, Apurvi is a killer when she starts. And the other comment he's made is 11-0 under pressure, which we have been talking about. 11-0 under pressure so far hasn't really, you know, delivered the goods. She has done well in a couple of World Cups, lekin wo thoda bahut concern. And yeah, in terms of risk, Weber, as you were saying, risk mein see, I will say this, diversification of risk and all is okay. Lekin mujhe batao, when we are shooting for an Olympic medal, do you want to go all in or do you want to diversify or do you want to hedge?
I would want to go all in if I have a clear cut demarcation, but it was a very very thin margin between Anjum and Apurvi, right?
Yeah,
not a great margin was separating them.
Yeah, that's a valid point. I mean, I will just say ki in you know, when you're going for an Olympic medal, you would rather have a situation ke high risk, high reward. You know, Olympic medal is a high reward. It's not a low reward. Low risk, low reward. Mein, so, theek hai. In this case, you know, it's like if let's say Apurvi comes back to her form, then she could have gone and won two medals. Jabki Anjum will, you know, if she's not in form, then Apurvi ka, we miss out on mixed medal. And similarly, ulta ho sakta hai. It's like if Anjum is in a form, we miss out on the individual medal. But yeah, I would have preferred if, you know, they decided on one rather than two. I think it's more of a compromise solution, because both of them were, you know, having problems in 2021, and Ilavanil was doing well, and both
exactly.
of them, and both of them are
same story, right? It's not like he one was performing, other wasn't performing. Both of them had exactly same story while winning quota as well as while going down. So it was very, very difficult to separate the two. And that is why probably they decided ki chalo theek hai ekko mix mein bhejte hain, ekko individual.
I think it's also a bit of a compromise solution in order to satisfy both of them, because eventually both are quota holders.
Perhaps. We still give good advantage to the quota holders.
Yeah, and you know, also matlab, we have to talk a little bit, you know, everything is not so clean as well. Thoda bahut isme politics bhi involved hota hai. So I don't know if that
but,
came into
yeah, play. I think let's not get into that. Let's focus only on the stats.
But okay, anyways, whatever it is, I would have preferred they would have selected one. Also, you know, Anjum ki case mein, now she has to focus on two events. Agar phir, you know, if you had to send Apurvi only, then let her shoot and mix as well, and let Anjum focus on 50 meter. So that at least from the day the selection is declared, she then only primarily focuses on 50 meters, right? So I would have preferred that, but theek hai. Whatever is now, obviously they are going, and we obviously will wholeheartedly support all of them. Nothing like it is all three of them come with medals, but theek hai. Everybody can dream. And and another comment was Ilavanil ka wo bhi tha ki, you know, she shot poorly in the Ausjek qualifiers in the beginning, but mixed team mein she had pulled up. Mixed team jab tak aaya tha,
even in the qualification she was able to overcome the initial two rounds, right?
So वही शुरू में थोड़ा वीक था, बट देन शी केम अप एंड मिक्स टीम में स्पेशली इन दैट सेकंड क्वालिफिकेशन वेर इंडिया कुड नॉट गेट टू मेडल मैच बिकॉज दिव्यांश हैड अ बैड परफॉर्मेंस बट इलावनिल वाज टेरिफिक इन दैट सेकंड राउंड ऑफ क्वालिफिकेशन.
आई थिंक वन मेजर पॉइंट फॉर मी एटलीस्ट व्हेन आई लुक एट 10 मीटर एयर राइफल वुमेन इज ऑफ कोर्स आई कीप ऑन हार्बोरिंग ओवर द इंटेंस कॉम्पिटिशन दैट इज देयर. We spoke about Iranians, Koreans, Chinese, and imagine we haven't even spoken about the Europeans.
Exactly.
Now again, European, almost every country has their own set of, you know, a shooter who at her day can easily score 630. Then there are people, there could be shooters in the US. We have a example from last year, Rio Olympics, Virginia Thrasher. So even in this Excel only couple, if we just do a sorting from their max scores. Let's say
scores,
if
right?
we just check the max qualification scores.
Ah, max scores, okay.
So you yourself will get to see there are at least 30 shooters who have this ceiling of getting a 630 on their day, which tells me the story that how unpredictable this particular event is. Right. So the vastness of field is immense.
Yeah, max mein actually Apurvi and Ilavanil come right on top. Not right on top, but pretty high. So Apurvi 4th, Ilavanil 5th, Mehuli right there at 6th. And tab bhi, you know, China, Iran, India hi hai top mein, agar dekhenge toh. But obviously, but you know, all these scores are good enough, you know, right up till like 629.2, maybe not 620, at least up till like 629.8. So all these shooters, you know, good, how many you have? About 20 odd shooters. All of them, you know, they have the capability of shooting well. But theek hai, China, India. I think Europeans mein the one name we didn't talk about is, at least based on this analysis, was this Ilil Laura Georgeta from Romania. Not many would have heard of her.
Yes, she's been doing pretty well recently. And I think she's entering with a great form.
Yeah, and I'll just say, by the way, her name is somewhere Komen Laura and somewhere it is Ilil Laura. Meri file mein bhi mereko adjust karne mein fight hua thoda. But basically because she must have got married. So not many people know about her, but she has got to 3 finals, but she's been a weak final shooter. And wo thoda factor hai, but she's there. And the another name I've seen in the chat, Carolyn Tucker-Merry, who someone was claiming is the most consistent shooter, but she's even had her problems. You know, 617.1 bhi shoot kiya hai. She did get the gold in Delhi, but...
I would like to add another name here. There was this Chinese Taipei shooter. I just saw her name, Lin Ying. And she was in red dot form in throughout the 2018 World Cup season. And I remember her vividly because I remember I was tracking the Munich 2019 scores. And that was the first time I saw someone shooting a 107 in qualification.
Oh, okay. 107.0.
Can we just check Lin Ying?
Yeah, Lin Ying is there. The average is very low. She's
average is low. Possibly she's not doing that great recently.
And also, you know, minimum, dekho, 617.5. So, up and down. Basically, up and down. Max is also 629.
Yeah, Lin Ying Shi.
So, 107 acha tha, but Max so she's, is 629.
She's made a couple of finals.
Yeah,
a couple of finals. In World Championship and then.
Yeah, but World Championship final is obviously nothing to scoff at. Very highly competitive event. And another bronze. So, she's okay. But, theek hai. We have... But yeah, obviously, Virginia Thrasher is the best example. Hone ko kuch bhi ho sakta hai. And that is valid, you know, across shooting all events. Isme maybe thoda jyada because everything is so close and everything is decimal scores. So, kahin pe kuch ho sakta. One thing we haven't focused yet is on the final. Ek thoda final dekh le, ki final mein who's doing well. Looking at the results just, so I'll see it.
Digvijay in the comments says that we should also be looking at who, which are the shooters presently training under Hines and Gabby. So guys, for all of you, Hines and Gabby are the coaches who under whom actually Abhinav Bindra was training when he went and shot the gold at Beijing. And there have been other medalists as well who've trained under them. And I think almost every Olympics, one or the other medalist has been training under them before coming to the Olympics. If I'm not wrong, Nico Campriani has also trained under them. Not sure though.
Okay.
That's a good point. I mean, we can actually look for which shooters are presently training.
At least I haven't looked at that. Diggy, if you know, you can also just put it in the comments. By the way, thanks a lot for joining. We never said, but thanks a lot for joining the stream in the first place. And if you know, you can also put it in the comments. Which are those shooters that they are training? And but yeah, it's there. And finals mein agar hum dekhe to there is this theek hai, that's just one final, Dennis Hester. Final mein Ilavnil actually has done very well. She shot just two finals.
Yeah.
But the average is very high. 10.455. As Weber was saying earlier, one of the few shooters jiska final average is higher than the qualification average. And there's this Korean also.
And even in the juniors, whenever she used to shoot in finals, she used to shoot quite great. Like I don't remember if she's won anything below silver. A lot of golds and a silver. So she's a great final shooter.
You're saying in juniors, right?
Juniors, yes.
And uske alawa, yeah, even Imhana, jo the reigning world champion, essentially. World championship ke baad kuch kiya nahi. And she's anyways not, but she's not going, right? We decided she's not.
No, going. She's not.
She's not going. So, theek hai, just based on that one final, she has a high average. But, you know, if you look at people who have shot multiple finals here, multiple finals, mein, at least two finals, ka if you put a barrier, Ilavnil actually has the highest. Because the three shooters above her all have shot just one final. So, two shot. Mein, and, you know, even here, Apurvi stands out to me. Number mein, theek hai, she might be like, you know, the list might show you like she's a 7th or 8th. But that 7th or 8th is over 4 finals, guys. That is a big deal. 8 final, 2 final, theek hai. But you know, over 4 finals, that's a big deal. And by the way, the other thing, the other analysis which I had done, there's only Apurvi, Anjum and Ili from Romania who have made it to 4 finals. Everybody else is, you know, maximum 3 finals. So if you see Anjum also made it to 4 finals. And in fact, Ili is also 3 finals and everybody else is 2 finals, yes. So only Apurvi and Anjum out of these 7 events have made it to 4 finals. And we have this Romanian shooter who didn't get a single medal but made it to 3 finals. And everybody else is maximum 2. So whatever that says, matlab, that much how much we were dominating in 2019. But theek hai, things have changed a little. This used to be event where we had the world number 1, 2 and 3. So I don't think it's any longer that kind of event, but hopefully we will see something here. And it's also an historic event from India's perspective, right? Anjali Vedpatak used to shoot in this event, and uske baad bhi we have had some nice shooters. Suma Shirud, one of the earliest Indian finalists in an Olympic, used to shoot in this event. Dipali Deshpande.
We have Avneet Sindhu as well.
So yeah, we would all, you know,
I think Avneet Sindhu was even before Anjali Bhag.
I think Satme the similar. Maybe स्टार्ट पहले किया
आसपास ही
होगा,
थे। हाँ
स्टार्ट
तो
पहले किया होगा तो
हाँ
पता नहीं, बट या सो इन दैट सेंस यू नो एयर राइफल बोथ इन वुमेन एंड मेन इज अ बिट ऑफ अ हिस्टोरिक इवेंट, सो इट विल बी गुड। एंड द अदर थिंग ऑल्सो, इट इज द फर्स्ट इवेंट ऑन द फर्स्ट डे गाइस, सो आई डोंट नो अक्रॉस द बोर्ड क्या है, बट आई थिंक एयर राइफल वुमेन गोल्ड विल बी द फर्स्ट गोल्ड हैंडेड आउट अक्रॉस द एंटायर ओलंपिक्स अक्रॉस ऑल स्पोर्ट्स। तो इमेजिन इफ वी कैन
दैट्स
डू
बीन द
समथिंग,
केस सिंस 2008 बीजिंग।
सो जस्ट इमेजिन इफ वी कैन डू समथिंग इन दिस इवेंट ऑन डे वन, एंड यू नो इट विल बेसिकली बी एज दे से धमाका इन इंडिया, धमाका हो जाएगा, बिकॉज वी ऑल्सो हैव मीराबाई चानू ऑन द फर्स्ट डे, एंड देन द 10 मीटर एयर राइफल विल बी फॉलोड बाई सौरभ चौधरी in 10 meter pistol and Abhishek always lives a bit in the shadow of Saurabh, but even Abhishek is there, so that first day
couple year
stop. Meri awaaz aa rahi hai?
Yeah, go on.
Theek hai, so
I'm saying your final concluding takeaway from this.
So my final concluding takeaway, 10 meter air rifle woman, I am definitely not as happy as I was in 2019. In 2019, I thought it was one of the strongest events, and the fact that it was first gave me a lot of hope. After now, I have some concerns. I would say best chance out of Ilavanil and Apurvi, I will at this point go with Ilavanil, but if Apurvi can come back, nothing like it. But yeah, it's a very deep event, kuch bhi ho sakta hai, and it won't be surprising if both of them miss out on the final as well, because they have been
consistent. Exactly. It's pretty simple that our girls can win a medal, but we shouldn't be, you know, raising our expectations too high considering all the factors that we have discussed so far talking about this event. Very, very deep.
Yeah. Okay. So I think we'll move on to the men then. Yeah, Diggy saying women's AR will be a pleasant surprise if we win, which I don't think you would have said that in 2019, Diggy, but yeah, situation has changed. So let's move to men then. So this is the men file. Same file, guys. All the analysis is the same. Weber, maybe tujhe dikhegi in like 5 seconds in your stream. And at the top, we have an Indian, Arjun Babuta, but that's just based on one event. So it doesn't really count. And Weber, you can see the file. Weber? अरे वैभव डिस्कनेक्ट हो गया क्या? आज ही डिस्कनेक्ट होना था. ओके, वैभव इज डिस्कनेक्ट. अच्छा, वैभव इज बैक. वैभव, यू आर बैक?
या या,
अच्छा ठीक है. ओके, आई डिडंट इवन रियलाइज टू डिस्कनेक्ट हो गया था बीच में एक बार.
मैंने भी रियलाइज नहीं किया टिल द टाइम इट पॉपड अप कि हां इंटरनेट डिस्कनेक्टेड.
ठीक है, एनीवे, सो वी आर ऑन 10 मीटर राइफल मैन, एंड एयर राइफल मैन में सबसे पहला जो दिखता है कि यू नो अर्जुन बबूता इज एट द टॉप, बट दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन वन इवेंट. एंड अगेन यहाँ पे यू नो अगेन चाइना इज ऑलवेज देयर, तुम कुछ भी कर लो, चाइना कहीं नहीं जा रहा है. मैस्लिकोव इज गुड.
इवन बियॉन्ड चाइना, आई फील दिस पर्टिकुलर इवेंट हैज सम बिग वेट्स, लाइक देयर आर ओलंपिक चैंपियंस, वर्ल्ड चैंपियंस, रशियंस, यूरोपियंस आर ऑल्सो गुड इन दिस, सो अ लॉट ऑफ हेविली कॉन्टेस्टेड फाइनल.
जिसमें से भी एक एमक्यूएस किया, तो दो ही इवेंट खेला है. ओ एक्चुअली ओके, दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. दो ही इवेंट खेला है एंड गोल्ड इन बोथ. Whatever,
and he I think missed out on this Croatian World Cup, and that was the first time in my memory I saw him not entering the final.
No, but not based on my analysis at least. I don't think he participated in Croatian World Cup. Check karna hai tujhe? Check kar
le. Yeah, he did. You talk about Kaminski, right?
हाँ, 50 में था के उसमें 10 में.
10 meter में था, but he didn't qualify for final.
Okay. ठीक है, आई डोंट नो,
दैट्स व्हाई इट्स नॉट शोइंग हियर.
नहीं नहीं, मेरा इवेंट नंबर भी 3 ही है ना. अच्छा नहीं, हां सॉरी, 3 इवेंट्स एंड 1 एमक्यूएस. ओके,
अभी तो 3 है ना.
हां सॉरी, मेरा मिस्टेक, मैं खुद ही अपने नंबर्स पे कंफ्यूज हो गया यार, क्या करता हूं मैं, खुद अपने नंबर्स पे कंफ्यूज हो गया.
एंड दिस मेस्लिनिकोव गाय, ही इज आई थिंक मेडलिस्ट फ्रॉम लास्ट ओलंपिक्स एज वेल, रियो ब्रॉन्ज या सिल्वर जीता था.
ठीक है, दैट आई एम नॉट श्योर, बट या इसने भी 3 इवेंट्स, 1 सिल्वर, 1 फोर्थ. And Sergey Kaminski, he missed out in Croatia, as he's saying, but teen event mein 2 gold. And Yu Zhichang, I think he's another one. Char event, fourth, bronze, gold. Name Tayun, by the way. This is another interesting name. Name Tayun from Korea. He's been shooting everything, six events. But he actually never managed to, you know, secure the direct quota. He got to four finals. Okay. The Delhi one was, quota was not available. Lekin yahan teen jagah he got to the final. But he missed out on the quota. And he eventually got his world ranking quota. So that is Name Tayun. And
by the way, let's... if we are talking about the big weights, Yang Haraon is back. So we have often spoken about Yang and, you know, how he essentially effed up during the Tokyo Rio Olympics. Before that, he was on a high run, winning golds World Cup after World Cup. So he's made another comeback, apparently, of course, from the qualification system that China had. So yeah, it'll be very exciting to see if he can, you know, have that closure of not getting to win a gold in Rio, but now coming back again and winning it in Tokyo.
Yeah, and Yang Haraon ka is baar ka interesting story ye bhi hai. He won the quota in the 50 meter rifle three positions, but so uske baad obviously he won't get the 10 meter quota because he won in 50 meter. But he's going in 10 meter and he's going in 10 meter only. 50 meter
mixed as well. Yeah.
10 meter. He's basically going in 10 meters. But 50 meter rifle three positions, mein China is sending two other shooters. So even though Yang Haraon won the quota and he won it right at the beginning in the world championship, he's not going to be competing in 50 meter, but he'll compete in 10 meters. And yehi hai. So Yang Haraon. And Indians, if you look at it, Aishwarya Pratap Singh Tomar. His average is actually final ke sab, his average is actually pretty good, Aishwarya Pratap Singh Tomar, but then it's just two events. So do hi event hai, but he did well in Osijek. He got to the finals and he's basically shot a 628 and a 632. So 628 is decent, 632 is obviously stunning, and jiske wajah se his average has got very high. There is a little bit of hype around him. He's a little too young, obviously inexperienced. You don't know kya hoga, but I think he's a bit of a dark horse. Kya lagta hai tujhe, Vaibhav?
Yeah, possibly.
Or let me put it this way. He would have been dark horse if he was going. But he's obviously not going in 10 meters.
Haan, matlab 10 meters ke liye toh, like, given the form he is in right now, if he was participating in 10 meters, so yeah, one could have considered him as well. But mera ye hai, before we move on to Indians, so we were taking names for some of the big guys, right? So 10 meter air rifle mein, I don't know. So even when you consider that, okay, there are certain guys who are not in the greatest of the form right now, but they've been Olympic medalists, world medalists from their previous years. So we do need to consider those guys as well. And like I was just scanning through the list and a couple of names I have. One is Pulish from Ukraine. Yes. So again, we got to see him in the 53P when Aishwarya was participating and he won a gold or a silver there in the Croatia World Cup.
It's a gold. I think so.
It's a gold, okay. Yeah. So yeah, he's the one to watch out for and he medaled in Rio as well last time.
But is he going? I think 10 meter mein ek hi quota hai. So is he going? Let's see.
But if he's going in 53P, so naturally he'll go for 10 meter air rifle as well, right?
I think they don't have a quota in 50 meter 3P. In fact, their quota is in 10 meter only. Aisa funda.
Okay. Okay.
So I'm just checking if I have a list. Go ahead. Yeah.
Because last time, jaise AB ka bhi hua tha na. So naturally, Abhinav Bindra, he didn't win even a single medal in the Rio Olympic cycle. Wasn't shooting that great, but whatever preparation he did in that last 2 to 3 months, that is what came in handy and which is what he kind of capitalized in, you know, qualified for the finals. So that experience does count if you've already won a world championship medal or an Olympic medal. So is tarike ke bhi kafi shooters in the mix already hai in 10 meter air rifle men. Wasn't the case specifically for women, but 10 meter air rifle men mein, like Maldiv Enyu is one. I think he's a London gold medalist, if I'm not wrong. Romanian guy. So he's again not shooting that great, but still he has that experience of winning an Olympic medal, so that does count.
Moldovino, since you raised Moldovino, he was actually the guy who won gold ahead of Gagan Narang in London. So Moldovino won the gold and Gagan Narang won the bronze, but Romania failed to win the quota. 10 meter mein bhi nahi hai, 50 meter mein bhi nahi hai.
Okay.
So Moldovino nahi ja raha hai. And yeah, Kulish ke baare mein I checked, Ukraine has just one quota, which is in the 10 meter. It was actually won by Oleg Sarkov towards the end of the World Cups. And Oleg Sarkov, and they haven't yet, at least Wikipedia doesn't have the list ki who's going. So they might send Kulish, they might send somebody else. So Oleg Sarkov, you know, at the number 37 yahan pe. At least if you look at the, and Sergei Kulish, at least average-wise, he's not there. 10 meter mein he's not there.
Yeah.
7 event shoot kiya hai. It's not like he's not shot. 7 event mein maximum is 627.6. So, I think he's more of a 50 meter. I don't think he's that much.
I mean, the point being, a lot of big weights in the mix. We even haven't spoken about the Hungarians, the Croats. Yeah. Peter Gorsa is there. He's a popular guy these days among us. So, a lot of shooters who can actually on their day
can do wonders. Hungary ki mujhe definitely baat karni hai. What do you say we take first? We take India first or we take Hungary first? India wale end mein
let's go to India at the end. If we have any other big names that you can think of.
Okay. So Hungary guys, I really need to talk about. I don't know how many of you guys know the story. Lekin Hungary shooting mein basically ghamasan ho raha hai right now. पीटर सिडी जो यहाँ पे मेरी लिस्ट में 16th है एंड देयर इज इस्तवान पेनी. इस्तवान पेनी आई थिंक इज द करंट वर्ल्ड नंबर वन, दो वट एवर वर्ल्ड नंबर वन बेसिकली मीन्स यू वन गोल्ड एट द लास्ट वर्ल्ड कप. ठीक है. सो Istvan Penny and Peter Sidi mein, there is quite a lot of tussle. It started at the Delhi World Cup, where what happened was ke, they were supposed to shoot a team match against India. I think it was 50 meters, probably. Maybe not 10 meters. And yeah, I think okay. It was 50 meters probably. But yeah, they were supposed to shoot a team match against India. And they pulled out because Penny had a problem with Sidi's gun. So Penny was basically saying that Sidi's gun is illegal. He had put some tripod on it, which he said was used as a counterbalance. And so there was a dispute there. So Penny said that Sidi has an illegal gun, and that's why he refused to shoot with Sidi in a team. And ISSF basically said that Sidi's gun is all right. There is no problem. So Sidi is like, gun barabar hai, kuch problem nahi hai. I don't know Penny ko kya problem hai. Faltu kehna kar raha hai. And uske baad, then there was a new story where what happened was that Penny got popped for doping. So he got a positive doping result. Weber, you are still there, right? I'm just confirming. So Penny got a doping result, and people thought ki he was gonna get banned. But hua kya ke Penny claimed ke sabotage. So Indian history is there, guys. But let's leave that aside.
It was something very similar to what happened in wrestling.
Yeah, but usko bhul jao. It's a different case. Yahan pe Penny alleged sabotage. And in this case, they actually had a CCTV camera of Sidi entering Penny's room and staying in Penny's room for 45 minutes when Penny was not there. So they actually had a CCTV camera. Yahan pe Sidi aata hai, he has a key card. He enters Penny's room and he doesn't come out for 45 minutes when Penny is not in the room. And Penny said that Sidi has, you know, poisoned his supplements or whatever. And that is what has caused the doping. And iska result tha chuka hai. The result was that Sidi was banned and Penny is playing. So Peter Sidi, who's, you know, number 16 in the list and would have been a top contender in Tokyo. And he's also an very experienced shooter. He shoots both 50 meter and 10 meter. I think maybe 50 meter is a little better than 10 meter. But he shoots both 50 meters and 10 meters.
Yeah.
And he's currently been banned. And he, by the way, then later defended himself saying ke, I had gone because Penny ne hi mujhe bulaya tha. He basically came up with a story that previous day, Penny had called me into his room to discuss about the gun. Jo unka gun ka, and all this happened in Delhi. Huh? Even the doping positive came out from Delhi. So all this happened in Delhi. एंड सिटी सेड के पेमी हैड कॉल्ड मी टू हिज रूम ओके एंड ही हैड टोल्ड मी कि आई विल गो फॉर द वर्कआउट विद माई डैड और फिर मैं जल्दी खत्म करके वापस आ जाऊंगा सो माई डैड इज स्टिल आउट एंड द यू एंड मी कैन टॉक इन अ रूम एंड पेमी एक्चुअली गेव हिज ओन की टू सिटी एंड टोल्ड की सिटी यू कैन कम इन टू द रूम वेट फॉर मी फॉर 5-10 मिनट्स आई विल गेट देर इन केस यू गेट देर फर्स्ट. तो सिटी सेट के पेनी ने मेरे को चाबी दिया मैं वो चाबी दे के वहां पे गया. आई एंटर्ड द रूम आई वॉज वेटिंग फॉर हिम कि वो आएगा एंड उसने यहां तक बोला कि आफ्टर गोइंग इन साइड द रूम आई स्टार्टेड यू नो प्लेइंग विद माई फोन आई गॉट बिजी विद माई फोन एंड आई डेंट रियलाइज के 45 मिनट्स हो गए. आई वॉज जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर हिम एंड देन यू नो वंस आई वॉज बिजी विद द फोन देन सडनली आई रियलाइज 45 मिनट्स हो गए आई नी वेरी इजी आई डोंट नो छोड़ो नाउ आई एम लिविंग. सो दैट्स हाउ ही लेफ्ट. सो दैट इज द स्टोरी विच ही केम अप. So this is all still going in the Hungarian shooting.
Is it still going on or have they concluded it and iska kuch outcome hua hai?
I mean, I don't know agar uske baad kuch hua, lekin the what I have read so far is ki city is banned, Penny is being favored because you have it on camera, right? City just has a story. Penny ke case mein you have it on camera ki you know he went into the room and in any case, is case mein Penny ko tum ban to kar hi nahi sakte, kuch bhi ho jaye because you know he has a simple. Straight up case where there has been a dispute. There's no doubt that there has been a dispute. There has been a dispute, and he's saying that somebody went into my room for 45 minutes. And I was positive. And anyways, it's shooting, right? Shooting the positive drug. You know, you would imagine steroids don't help much in any case. So you obviously can't ban Penny here, but at the moment, at least Siddhi is banned. And jahan tak mujhe pata hai.
Also, they can't afford to lose him, I think, Penny is the man, because he's a huge medal prospect in both the events.
Yeah, he's the younger guy. Siddhi is the experienced guy. Penny is the younger guy. But Penny has overtaken Siddhi on most metrics at the moment, especially in 50 meters.
Peter Siddhi, by the way, if you remember, we were discussing on Twitter as well once. He's one of those shooters who has achieved quite a lot of medals. In the World Cup, but nothing in Olympics. Yeah.
And so Penny ke saath right now, from what I understand, Zalan Pekler will be going, who had a great World Cup in Osijek. He hasn't done much before that. He's competed in 6 World Cups. So uske pehle kuch nahi kiya. He's even had like 620s and all. But in Osijek, he shot a 631.5, which was one of the top scores. I think it was second or third in qualification or something. Chat is still on, right? Mera chat update nahi ho raha hai. Theek hai. Chat is still on, right?
Check. Update nahi ho raha hai, but yeah, it's connected. And guys, if you're enjoying the video, you're liking the analysis, why don't you hit a like and keep up the video?
Yeah.
So that it's there in the algorithms.
Yeah, guys, just like the video. It doesn't cost you anything. And the YouTube algorithm is such, you know, that this video gets shared and promoted by YouTube if there are more likes. So if you guys are there, just make that like click. Utna ek kar do for us. And by the way, we have about 66 viewers. I think this is the maximum we have had. Otherwise, we usually used to be in the 50s. So, yeah, Zaklan Pekler is the other guy who will be going with Penny. But this is a major story. And I think maybe 10 meter, mein these guys are maybe not that strong. What do you say, Vaibhav? 50 meter, mein I think, jyada hai.
Penny is the one, I would still say, yeah. I think his main event is 53P. Hmm. But I would never discount him for 10 meter air rifle also.
हाँ मतलब डिस्काउंट तो किसी को ही नहीं कर सकते बट ठीक है वी हैव यू नो अदर ऑप्शंस एज वेल हिज हाईएस्ट एज
लाइक ही इज ऑलवेज इन द मिक्स इवन इफ नॉट क्वालिफाइंग फॉर फाइनल्स बट ही इज ऑलवेज बीन देयर इन टॉप 10 टॉप 15
या
मतलब गुड हाई सीलिंग
एंड देन देयर इज ऑफ कोर्स पीटर गोसा क्रोएशिया हु ऑनेस्टली यू नो फॉर इंडियंस पीटर गोसा इज राइट नाउ बेसिकली योर सेकंड सपोर्ट आफ्टर द इंडियंस. So for those who don't know, Peter Gosa is the guy who basically did everything to get India to Croatia. So the entire Indian shooting team right now is training in Croatia. They competed in the Croatia World Cup as well. And Peter Gosa had a huge hand in this. He did a lot, you know, for managing the visas, getting the permissions and everything. And you know, the connect of Peter Gosa with India actually started in Delhi, where he came to Delhi and he got COVID. तो दिल्ली में आते से ही कोविड हो गया सो देन ही डिडंट कम्पीट इन द दिल्ली वर्ल्ड कप एंड बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड ही वाज पुट इन द हॉस्पिटल सो ही वाज वेरी अनहैप्पी विद द हॉस्पिटल ही वाज असिम्प्टोमैटिक सो ही इज लाइक जाने दो क्या है एंड इवेंचुअली यू नो रनिंदर सिंह एक्चुअली टुक हिम इन हिज होम सो रनिंदर सिंह हु इज द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ NRAI ही एक्चुअली टुक यू नो पीटर गोसा इन हिज ओन होम अ कोविड पॉजिटिव पीटर गोसा इन हिज ओन होम विच इज यू नो बिग डील एंड पीटर गोसा वॉज सो थैंकफुल both to Naninder, both to India. Even Ranjan Sodhi apparently played a huge role behind the scenes, and he then basically moved heaven and earth to get the Indian team to Croatia. His own training maybe took a little bit of hit, but he didn't care. So Peter Gosa, for all Indians guys, that's your second support after the Indians. Weber?
Yeah. So yeah, and he's been shooting great as well. Like he's had a kid very recently, and he's been juggling all the personal and, you know, his shooting career, and shooting great as well. As you can see, 3 silvers and a bronze. So yeah. Also, Kapil, one more name I would want to highlight here is Sergei Richter from Israel. Now, Israel is not a very prominent shooting country and does not come forth very easily. But yeah, he's been on a great form. And outside of these 3 finals that he's been in the last 3 World Cups, he's won a European Games gold as well pretty recently. So he's in a great touch and could be one of those guys who can spring a surprise. Yeah. In Tokyo.
I think he's one of the guys, you know, Israel anyways hit nahi karta hai. Plus, is list mein he's 15th, which is like not the highest. But if you look at recent form, he is right there. But abhi tak medal nahi hai, Sergei Richter. He's done very well in the qualification.
Medal nahi hai. European Games mein gold jeeta, but theek hai, that is also like a good high-level competition, if you want to consider that.
Yeah, so medal nahi
hai. World Cup pe medal.
And Koreans ki baat nahi ki apan ne, but theek hai, Koreans I guess 10 meter rifle mein maybe not men mein maybe not that strong, but Koreans you can never count out.
It's somewhat similar to women, no?
Nahi, but women I think they are stronger.
Strong nahi hai.
But I think women mein they are stronger.
They have a medal to show, that's why.
Haan, wo bhi baat theek hai.
Yeah. Yahan pe consistency zyada hai among men. As you'll see, there are 4 finals entered by this Nam Taeyun.
Yeah, or he missed the quota, right? मैं वही बोला कि he eventually got a world ranking quota after entering 4 finals.
Okay.
So 4 final, no quota, so, and eventually world ranking quota मिला.
Yeah.
So we look at the.
But where are
the Indians?
Do you have any other names?
I think we are more or less there. Let's look at the Indians.
Yeah.
So Indians में Divyansh is your top name, and Deepak Kumar कहाँ गया? Okay. Deepak Kumar, he's a little controversial in India. Lot of people felt that, you know, Aishwarya Tomar or somebody else should have been replaced. I personally didn't feel so. Aishwarya has done well in the last couple of events, but eventually, you know, Deepak Kumar, okay, he's not the top shooter, but he is also there and thereabouts. And he's been in, you know, 8th ke baad bhi, maybe, you know, 12, 13 ki range mein rehta hai. He had, I think, decent World Cup in Osijek. He was close to the final. He didn't get there. I was following the live score as well. He missed out. But and he's also made the World Championship final.
Yeah, and he kind of justifies his selection as well.
Yeah, and he also has
two bar final.
Two bar final, including the World Championship. So, World Championship may be final. And he's also shot 630. Not, he won't be our best hope for the medal. But yeah, shooting hai. But theek hai, there is some validity that maybe we could have selected someone else. But then, usme bhi domestic trials hue, everything we have had. And Tomar is anyways going for 50 meters. So, it might be better. Tomar was a bit of a late bloomer, basically. It was a little too late in the day, you know, to switch him for Deepak. And Deepak has done, except for winning medals, Deepak has basically done everything that's asked of him. He has done well in the mixed team event. He's shooting consistently. Doesn't really get to the final. Give eye performances, but he's been shooting consistently and done everything, and he deserved his spot. That's in my opinion.
Yeah, and I am very fascinated by his background. Actually, remember when I think Asian Games he had won something, right? Was it silver or a bronze? Some medal he had fetched in Asian Games.
I think I'll have to.
That is where the story came in, that how he's brought up in a Gurukul somewhere in Uttarakhand, and that is where his roots are. Quite fascinating.
And I think pehle to wo tha na, Deepak Kumar and Ravi Kumar, those were like your big two guys going into world championships, and uske baad Panwar came in. So if you look at Panwar, he didn't compete in the world championships. He's competed in 6 events, but he didn't compete in the world championships. And I think Delhi mein kota liya tha, nahi, theek hai, Beijing mein kota liya. Beijing में got the silver and he got the quota and वहाँ से he is really moved from you know strength to strength and but I have to say कि पनवार I you know looking at this record I thought he would be higher than where he is. He's always been a little bit you know up and down. So even if you look at the record, he got silver in Beijing, then bronze in Delhi 21, which barely counts. And Munich, I think he was in NQS. So because we still needed a quota. And then, Munich he competed and Rio he was in MQS. Huh? I checked this.
Probably Kapil, he's done fairly well in mixed. So that's why he's always been in the news and the chatter.
And mixed mein kya hai na, mixed mein wo sort of hit bhi karta hai. Because he's a slow shooter. And mix में generally he's you know always the last guy to shoot. So it's like तीनों का score आ गया होता है and then if you're watching live, तीनों का score आ गया होता है and then पनवार का you know last एक fourth shot आता है where you're hoping अरे shoot 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 and you have a target कि इतना shoot हुआ तो India gets the set and he's generally you know lived up to that. He has a mixed medals as well. So Divyansh पनवार, I have greater hopes for him than what this sheet shows. He's in 20th, but he had some weak scores to begin with. And I am hoping for the medal tournament. Little disappointed.
Basically, both of them will have to punch above their weights. It's as simple as that if they want to medal. Because right now, considering the level they are, it's a big task for them.
I think Divyansh ka, I think wo bhi tha. World Cup final mein bhi shayad gold hai. I'm not too sure, but medal definitely hai. World Cup final maybe. तो वो भी एक फैक्टर है बट आई एम होपिंग आई थिंक दीपक आई गेट व्हाट यू आर सेइंग ही विल हैव टू पंच अबव हिज वेट दिव्यांश ऑनेस्टली आई थिंक इफ ही कैन पुट इन हिज बेस्ट परफॉर्मेंस ही कैन गेट अ मेडल इट्स नॉट अ केस ऑफ पंचिंग अबव हिज वेट 629 का
वेल
व्हाट
फाइनल्स का भी इतना एक्सपीरियंस नहीं है ना सो आई एम नॉट श्योर इफ लाइक कंसीडरिंग द फील्ड दैट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस एंड इट्स ओलंपिक्स Well, I have my doubts.
But I think final average, I think he's pretty good. If you just have a look. He has only two finals to show here. But I think in the finals, he's pretty good. So I'll just sort based on the final. Okay, final. Okay. Yeah. So final, he comes very high. Like 7th. Okay.
Mm.
दो ही फाइनल है बट ठीक
है
एंड इनफैक्ट इफ यू सी मोस्ट पीपल हैव लाइक टू और थ्री फाइनल्स ओनली राइट पीटर गोल्सा स्टिल स्टैंड्स आउट यू नो पीटर गोल्सा इज प्रोबेबली इफ यू आर लुकिंग एट दिस लिस्ट एंड यू हैव टू पिक अ फेवरेट आई एम एक्चुअली गोइंग विद पीटर गोल्सा हियर ही हैज यू नो फोर फाइनल्स थ्री सिल्वर्स अ ब्रॉन्ज ही इज कम्पीटेड इन एंड इनफैक्ट ही इज कम्पीटेड इन जस्ट फोर इवेंट्स ही इज कम्पीटेड इन फोर इवेंट्स मेड द फाइनल एवरी टाइम थ्री सिल्वर्स एंड अ ब्रॉन्ज आई मीन No
yeah,
goals,
that's what like, and how do you even discount Chinese and the Russians?
Exactly,
it's very very rare they miss out on a fine.
Hmm. Yeah, but you know, looking at this list, if I have to pick one guy, who's maybe the favorite, besides the Chinese are a bit of an unknown quantity. But Chinese ke alawa, there is Peter Golsa. You said Yang Haolan is back. He is a big name.
And the other Chinese is totally unknown. I don't think he's even shot at a single World Cup.
देख लेते हैं ना वो तो we can have I think we saw right he was his name was at the bottom.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. वापस देख लेते हैं एक बार. I think his name was at the bottom. लेकिन मतलब कुछ किया नहीं है. Or maybe that was in the women. कौन है Chinese में 10 meter? नहीं हाँ वो उसमें था Sheng Lihao. Yeah. That was for the women, not for the men. So Sheng Lihao. Yeah, you're right. Not a single World Cup. Correct.
Yeah, Sheng Lihao.
Not a single World Cup, you're right. So take care, but
all in all, you feel that Divyansh still has a chance. I think both of them will have to punch above their weights. And there are like a lot of heavyweights in this event.
Even the Americans, you know, Kozniski. Kozniski, this is one name we keep seeing, but doesn't have too many medals to show at least. One gold in Delhi, that really doesn't count, and not the highest average as well. So, it's okay.
Yeah,
I think I would say Peter Golsa would be my number one, possibly Haudan, uske baad. And then the names which strike me are, you know, Penny, Divyansh, तो कुछ दिख नहीं रहा है. एंड कमिंस्की, या पेनी, दिव्यांश एंड कमिंस्की, मुझे ये पांच दिखते हैं. तुझे और कुछ दिख रहा है? यू हैव टॉक्ड.
आई फील चाइनीज, मतलब माय मेन कंटेंडर्स वुड बी द रशियंस एंड द चाइनीज फर्स्ट, एंड देन ऑफ कोर्स लाइक यू सेड पीटर गोसा. एंड उसके बाद लाइक आई कैन सी अ कोरियन आल्सो, बिकॉज़ कोरियंस हैव दिस, एटलीस्ट इन राइफल मैन जितना मेरे को याद है, दे यूज्ड टू हैव अ गुड पेडिग्री इन 53P एज वेल. और पहले भी उनकी 10 मीटर एयर राइफल में, मतलब दे आर नॉट ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द माइंड ऑफ पीपल, बट दे हैव हैड अ गुड पेडिग्री. सो मतलब फॉर मी इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू सी एनी ऑफ आर गाइज मेकिंग इट टू द फाइनल. सो थोड़ा सा उनको ये होना पड़ेगा, लाइक दे हैव टू बी एक्चुअली give the best ever performance that they have so far.
Yeah, so okay, guess difference of opinion here. I am definitely hoping Divyansh can do something. Aur kuch hai, or should we move to rifle team?
Yeah. I think so. Do you want to discuss mixed pair first?
Haan, mix karte hain.
After this,
by the way, Vaibhav, looking at the time, I think we need a second part, right? I don't think there's much.
Yeah, of course. There's no other option. So let's complete mixed pair and let's take another event, 25 meter pistol. What do you think?
Yeah, 25 meter pistol woman is good. So
then let's just wrap it there.
So we'll do mixed team, we'll do 25 meter pistol, and then guys, we'll have a second part of this to cover the remaining events, possibly somewhere during the week, but we'll let you know about the times. We'll figure out a time and we'll do a second part of this. And honestly, shooting deserves two podcasts, right? Or two streams.
Yes.
By the way, chat has gone slow, guys.
And we might do it in a midweek as well.
Yeah. By the way, chat
sometime
has gone,
later in the night.
Chat has gone slow. I guess Diggy left the chat. That's why maybe chat has gone slow. But chat is still open, yeah. Guys. If you have a questions, we can have a look at that.
Questions, if you have some of your own insights, just feel free to write, guys.
Mm. Yeah, even some comments, anything is welcome. And theek hai, this is now mixed team. Ab isme se I have obviously taken a few liberties, kyunki mixed team mein there's a lot of complication as to who will pair up with who, and even the data is not properly available. And in fact mixed team mein ek aur cheez hai which I have to do. One second, kidhar gaya, kidhar gaya, hold on. Yeah, Vaibhav, just talk about mixed team.
So I think for mixed team, like we keep on saying again and again, why India in particular has done fairly good in mixed team is because I think hamare dono genders ka agar hum dekhenge, so if we have good quality shooters in both the genders, which not many countries can boast of. Of course, jitne bhi major countries hain, your likes of China, Russia, I've been keeping on saying on these two names. So we kind of are able to compete with them because हमारे दोनों weightages equal है. So we've got good shooters in men as well as women. So on the top of the list only, if you can see, there are not many countries which crop up other than China, Russia. I can see Hungary as well.
Yeah, China.
Romania again.
Romania is not qualified. So they're in the list.
Romania is not qualified, of course.
Not
yeah.
qualified. Yeah. They're in the list.
So Hungary is the fourth country I can see in the mix. Then US is there and Norway. So yeah, like not many countries, right? So that gives us obviously a higher chance to win in this particular event than you have in individual event.
Yeah. And yeah, I mean, I'll just talk about this file a little bit. So basically, guys, what I've done is I've paired up one female with one male. And I basically used experience to do it. So the female who has shot in the most events, I paired up with the male who has shot in most events, because that's generally how they go about it. Doesn't always work. And obviously, teams also keep changing. So for example, India may be Anjum has shot with Divyansh, Anjum has shot with Deepak, Apulvi has shot with Deepak, Divyansh, Ila has also, I think, shot with both of them. So the teams, keep changing. So this is, sort of just an indicator. What the teams could look like and what the averages could be. So, jaise, if you look at China ka Yang Haodan and Zhao Duzhu, who's not going, have the highest average. But then Zhao Duzhu, if you replace with somebody else, the averages are gonna come out similar only. And so उस हिसाब से ना दिव्यांश got paired up with Ilavanil. That I manually did it. थोड़े बहुत I made manual changes because
we know he's paired with Anjum as well and won a couple of golds also.
Exactly. But हाँ, so in this sheet at least you know every name exists only once. तो अगर दिव्यांश को मैंने अंजुम से पेयर किया है तो देन आई थिंक इलावनिल सॉरी दिव्यांश को इलावनिल से पेयर किया है तो देन अंजुम आई थिंक गॉट पेयर्ड विद दीपक. सो इफ यू सी दीपक एंड अंजुम एट द बॉटम एंड देन अपूर्वी एंडेड अप गेटिंग पेयर्ड अप विद रवि कुमार बिकॉज दीपक एंड अंजुम विल बी शूटिंग एंड अपूर्वी विल नॉट बी शूटिंग. सो द पेयरिंग्स आर अ लिटिल रैंडम गाइस बट जस्ट टू गिव एन इंडिकेशन एंड ऑब्वियसली द कोटा एवरीथिंग स्टेज द सेम. You have average per shot in qualification. In medal matches, guys, this qualification, by the way, includes your qualification number one, number two. For those who don't know, right now, mixed team ka format ye hai, ki you have a qualification round where everybody shoots. Then the top eight qualify to a what they call qualification part two. And those top eight shoot again. Bebo, you're still there, right? You're not moving.
Yeah, I'm there.
Yeah, so that
so they shoot two more rounds in qualification.
Yeah, so you two. Move to qualification part two. The top eight teams move to qualification part two. You start back from zero, and then after qualification part two, the top two teams move to the gold medal match, and number three and number four move to the bronze medal match. So these medal matches which you see in the end, these are just like you know the averages which have been shot by the respective shooters in the few medal matches for which I have the data because. ये मेडल मैच का फॉर्मेट प्रॉपरली दे अडॉप्टेड इन बीजिंग लेकिन बीजिंग का भी डेटा है नहीं ISSF साइट पे. सो इट्स रियो ऑनवर्ड्स. सो द लास्ट फोर द वर्ल्ड कप्स विच इज सॉरी म्यूनिक ऑनवर्ड्स. सो द लास्ट फोर वर्ल्ड कप्स विच इज म्यूनिक रियो दिल्ली एंड ऑस्ट्रिया वो चार के फाइनल्स के ऊपर ये मेडल मैचेस का डेटा बेस्ड है. सो ओनली ऑन दोज फोर फाइनल्स. सो वॉट एवर इट मीन्स इट माइट नॉट मीन टू मच बट जस्ट यू नो गेट सम सॉर्ट ऑफ एन इंडिकेशन.
Kapil, there are a couple of questions in the chat asking if qualification part 2 will be broadcasted. I genuinely feel it's not going to be the case, even though you've asked Sony very vehemently if they should be making any plans to telecast it. But it's very difficult, right? They're going to telecast only final. How the trend has been so far for World Cups.
Yeah, but who cares about Sony's difficulty? Guys, I will just say right now, this was a pinned tweet on my Twitter profile for a long time. अब नाउ आई हैव स्टार्टेड द चैनल तो आई पुट द चैनल ट्वीट्स एज द पिन ट्वीट्स. प्लीज गो एंड बग सोनी. ओके, सोनी को अगले 20 दिन में परेशान कर दो कि मेक अरेंजमेंट्स टू यू नो टेलीकास्ट द क्वालिफिकेशन पार्ट टू.
नो बट इफ देयर इज अ लाइव टेलीकास्ट कमिंग फ्रॉम द ओलंपिक्स देन ओनली सोनी कैन आल्सो टेलीकास्ट इट.
व्हाई व्हाई फाइंड अ वे
टू डू इट. आई डोंट थिंक दे डू इट फॉर क्वालिफिकेशन.
या बट व्हाई फाइंड अ वे टू डू इट. मतलब सोनी ने पैसा दिया है. इफ देयर इज अ विल देयर इज अ वे. Find a way to do it. And in fact,
they can't keep the basics in place and you're expecting them to get into this level of detail.
I'm hoping. Because see guys, yahan pe, you know, there is a situation.
Basics apne wo fine tune kar le, wo hi bahut badi baat hogi.
Arre yaar, bina commentary ke dikhao, kuch bhi karke dikhao. Sony lift pe dal do. Sony pe mat dalo, Sony lift pe dal do. Kuch to karo. Because see guys, you have a genuine situation here. That a medal winning moment will not be telecast on TV. There will be no record, no video record other than some amateur recording. There will be no video record of that medal winning moment because after qualification 2, you have your gold medal match and your bronze medal match set up. So if you reach the gold medal match, that means your silver medal is guaranteed. And that silver medal celebration, that silver medal, you know, the moment when it happens, that is currently not gonna be broadcasted on Sony. So I will just say, bug them. We are not too many. We are, I don't know what we have, 70 viewers right now, 60 viewers, 65 viewers right now. Guys, unko bug karo. Maine bhi kiya hai thoda bahut. It won't happen, it won't make a difference, but there's no harm in trying. And especially, you know, rifle mein to phir bhi theek hai, pistol mein I'm really worried because pistol mein we have a very good teams and theek hai, maybe we haven't performed, the second team didn't do that well this time. But if you look at even the Osjek World Cup, which, you know, all of us thought was a weakest World Cup, even in our Osjek World Cup, our teams in the qualification ended second and third. Had that second and third been first and second, that means even your gold winning moment is not coming on TV, which is just atrocious. I mean, they have to figure out a way to do it, or they should figure out a way to do it. So since it came up, I will just say, guys, karo. Aur kuch nahi karte ho. Agar, अगर मेडल जीतते हुए देखना है सोनी को, बक करो और अभी से करो तो दे विल मेक अरेंजमेंट। 20 दिन बाद करोगे तो कुछ नहीं होगा, अभी से करोगे सो दे माइट मेक अरेंजमेंट्स। और अगर सोनी को नहीं करते हो जर्नलिस्ट को बक करो, जो भी उधर जा रहा है भैया कैमरा डाल के लाइव स्ट्रीम कर, कुछ कर समथिंग। ISSF लाइव टीवी कैन बी एन ऑप्शन, आई डाउट देवशीष अगर ISSF पे आएगा तो देयर इज अ गुड चांस कि सोनी पे भी आएगा। आई डोंट नो इफ दे डू समथिंग बट कीप बगिंग देम, दैट इज ऑल आई कैन से, दैट इज द बेस्ट थिंग वी कैन डू। इनफैक्ट दिस वॉज वन ऑफ माई यू नो बिगेस्ट बिगेस्ट डिसअपॉइंटमेंट्स व्हेन आई न्यू कि आई विल नॉट बी गोइंग टू टोक्यो, बिकॉज आई वॉज होपिंग टू गो टू टोक्यो एंड आई एम लाइक ओके टोक्यो जाएंगे ठीक है यहाँ पे प्रॉब्लम होगा, लेकिन एटलीस्ट आई विल बी देयर इन दैट मिक्स्ड टीम मैच वॉचिंग दैट मोमेंट इवन इफ इट डजंट कम इन टीवी। बट अब है ना वी आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन द टीवी एंड द ब्रॉडकास्टर्स, एटलीस्ट इवन आई एम डिपेंडेंट ऑन टीवी ब्रॉडकास्टर्स। सो जस्ट एन अपील फ्रॉम माई साइड गाइज, गो एंड बक सोनी ट्विटर, गो एंड बक देयर फेसबुक, जितना कर सकते हो करो। एंड या विघ्नेश कुमार, दैट इज वॉट वी आर टॉकिंग, you're saying final event will not be telecasted, I am not too sure which final event you're talking about, but if you're talking about general finals it should be there. Bronze and gold medal match,
Vignesh also has a question that
go ahead.
Complete on
So yeah, it's my life, bronze and gold medals will be telecasted but the qualification final 2 will not be telecasted is what I'm saying. So if an Indian team gets to the gold medal match, that's a silver guaranteeing moment which will not be on TV. Yeah, Anubhav, do it. Daily ka ek tweet, maro. Just maro, paka un log ko. Ki hai na, leke aao, tum log kya. And by the way, Vaibhav, you were saying ki arrangement kaise karenge? At least in, you know, previous Asian Games, previous Commonwealth Games, I've seen ki, you know, you have some events jahan pe final nahi hota hai. Jaise 50-meter prone woman. There is one event, 50-meter prone woman, which has been contested in Asian Games in the past, aur final nahi hua hai. And they have shown some sort of thing about it. You know, maybe thoda highlights, maybe show the last 10 minutes of it live, because now it's a final. Because you are shooting the 50-meter prone in the qualification, there is no separate final. So now this is like a final and they have shown it. So it's not like it can't be done. Okay? It can be done.
Theek hai, achhi baat hai if they do it.
Haan, Ranjinder ko bhi maro. I don't think he will do it. He is not really into broadcast and everything, jahan tak mujhe pata hai. Jisko paka sakte ho na, pakao. If there's one Twitter campaign which I can get through this stream, I would like ke get whoever is showing to say basically confirm ke yes, we will get the qualification part 2 if India is in there. And haan, Meer ko bolo achha camera leke jaye, good chance Meer leke jayega, journalist chhodne nahi wale, you'll have something but you don't know kitna hoga and whether they'll allow it, you know, Tokyo mein wo shooting karna allow bhi karna chahiye, especially with COVID and all, they are gonna be pretty Yeah, Vignesh, we are at least getting the gold medal match. But is that enough? I mean, if it's enough for you, okay. It's not enough for me. मतलब एक मैच देखने को ही तो बोल रहे यार, कौन सी बड़ी बात?
Yeah. Kapil, anything else on this 10-meter mixed pair?
Yeah, ये तो अभी चालू ही नहीं किया है, अभी तो उससे अपन वो बात कर रहे थे. So, so China.
I think we might need to wrap it up in 20-25 minutes. So.
हाँ, ठीक है, हो जाएगा. So this and women pistol, right? That's the target, that's okay.
Yeah.
हाँ ठीक है, so yeah, rifle team China, Russia, India and Hungary, those are the four guys which really stand out. And India mein you have Divyansh and Ilavanil, you have Deepak and Anjum have had weak build-ups to it, so they might be a little low in confidence. And Divyansh and Ilavanil are the big pair, and for me at least a big hope. Even in Osjek, if we see that, they got to the top 8 and they basically Divyansh had a weak qualification too. Jiske wajah se India 6th reh gaya. But uske alawa, they can do very well. Or in fact, usi mein Osjek mein, qualification 1 mein, they were like in the top 2 or top 3. Something like that. And in terms of qualification, Lakshya is asking how many teams have qualified in the mixed event. So Lakshya, you can look at the country quota. So country quota, at least all the top teams have 2. So usme koi kami nahi hai. You'll get enough teams, but yeah, obviously the field will not be as big as the remaining events because it's a team. You can look at the quota. Even niche tak, you have people. Jaise ye kaun hai? This is the Japan. Okay, Japan is a host, so that's fine. You even have Norway who 50-meter shooters can come and shoot in 10 meters. So it's not, there is a lot of zero as well, but you have to go down. out of the top names, the only one who's missed out is probably Romania, because Moldavia did not qualify, so Romania doesn't have a team. But yeah, उसके अलावा एंड हंगरी हैज ओनली वन टीम, दैट्स अनदर अनदर फैक्टर. हंगरी की एक ही टीम है, दो नहीं है. सो इस्तवान पेनी विल कम्पीट. एंड
यहाँ पे वन थिंग इंटरेस्टिंग वुड बी टू नोट इज इंडिविजुअल इवेंट्स के बाद स्केड्यूल्ड है मिक्स पेयर, राइट?
राइट.
सो अ लॉट ऑफ इट वुड डिपेंड ऑन द मूड एज वेल ऑफ द स्क्वाड, हाउ विद व्हाट काइंड ऑफ मूड दे आर एंटरिंग फॉर द मिक्स पेयर. अगर बहुत ही बड़ा एफ अप हुआ इन बोथ द इंडिविजुअल इवेंट्स, इट माइट drastically change things for us.
By the way,
at least for us it might.
So there was actually a repeated comment in the chat ke, you know, what happens if Apurvi wins a medal, which is a valid question. Any thoughts?
Well, even if she wins a medal, you can't change on the spot, right?
Yeah.
Or you can?
I don't know about the rules, but I don't think India is doing that. They must have thought that
Mm-hmm.
before, you know, picking the
team. I think they'll stick by the team that they've decided.
Yeah, and Apurvi then obviously will be in the celebratory mood if she actually wins the medal. There will definitely
be... Anjum ka bhi pata nahi hoga na, because Anjum till then might not have shot in 10 meter air rifle. Uh-huh. So, you might know with what form she's coming in the mixed pair.
That's fine. Lekin
so, even she might be shooting at that level.
But see, it's a valid question, right? India mein medal is medal. You now have a situation where somebody who's won an Olympic medal, okay, is not getting to shoot in what is virtually the same event, right? The entire skill required to shoot in 10 meter, whether it's an individual event or whether it's a team event, it's basically the same. There's not much teamwork.
Same.
Yeah, timing restrictions and everything are different.
Yeah, not team dynamics come in.
So team dynamic bhi kuch nahi hai. So, uske wajah se bhi, you know, I was even dicey ki, you know, they should have not split it between, you know, Apurvi and Anjum. They should have, you know, picked one and gone with her, because there can be some controversy here, you know, ki if Apurvi wins a medal and then says, ki, I hope they let me shoot in mixed team, then it's a problem. You don't want that, you know, one day before the Olympic event. I don't think it will happen. They would have, you know, talked about all these possibilities, but it's possible, and they will
definitely... Yeah, I don't think there's much in there for the controversy, because the teams have been out. Everyone knows who's been following shooting. Ki, haan, this is the basis of selecting a team. Theek hai, all good if Apurvi comes and wins a medal, but why should that change the narrative, right?
Because it's a medal. India mein medal
it is a medal, but you've chosen Anjum for a reason. Now let her also give a chance.
Yeah, theek hai. I mean, I get it. I agree ki it will not be changed. That I'm agreeing. Though I do think there will be some controversy in India. There will, even if Apurvi doesn't say anything, there will be, in my opinion, there will be some articles and some writers claiming that we need to change the team. That's all I'm saying. They don't matter. It's not gonna matter. But I think India mein thoda controversy to hoga. Let her shoot in.
But you know, I think let's do a little more research, or main at least karta hun ki, what is the exact rule there in Tokyo Olympics? Can you reform your team like a day or two before? Yeah, actually, tumhe pehle enter karni hoti hai mixed pair ki teams. Guys, does any one of you know about this rule? Kya?
Yeah.
Let us know in the chat. Because that might play a huge role there, right? Like, taking from your point only, if actually Apurvi medals, so, and there's a rule that you can decide the team just a day before also. So, they might change as well.
Yeah, theek hai. Even I haven't seen the rule, lekin mera guess hai ki it will not be there. Because agar, matlab changing will not be allowed. Because agar changing allowed hota na, then even ISSF, even NRAI would have recognized ki this is very dangerous. कि वो फिर दो दिन में यू डोंट वांट अ कैंपेन यू नो कि टीम चेंज करो. अब ठीक है, अलाउड ही नहीं है, तब तो हमारी स्टोरी खत्म हो जाती है. बट अगर अलाउड होता तो
नहीं, जैसे बाकी कंट्रीज में भी यू हैव टू शूटर्स फ्रॉम ईच जेंडर, सो यू कैन डिसाइड ऑन द कॉम्बिनेशन, राइट? लेट्स से ए शूटर ए एंड बी, मतलब देयर आर टू शूटर्स हु आर शूटिंग एक्सेप्शनली वेल इन बोथ द जेंडर्स एंड दे आर नॉट पेयर्ड अप एज ऑफ नाउ. So any country would want to decide that ki haan, ye dono best hai, to let's take the risk and go for them.
Yeah, I actually
That was I'm thinking.
remember Lakshya is claiming that Diggy said selection is open. I remember the, I think Diggy ne comment mara tha ki mixed mein selection is open. So if it is open, then there is a problem. Yeah, it could be a problem. And uske alawa, I think I had seen a couple of good questions here.
One of the question was that why don't they follow the same format that they do in individuals while doing this finals thing. So the thing is so the qualification and final ranges are two different ranges in the shooting venue. So finals you typically only find 8 to 10 slots, not more than that, whereas qualification you have a series of shooters at least say 30 to 50 who are standing side. Sorry?
Jada bhi, even 70, 80, however many.
Yeah, jada bhi ho sakte hain. So they are standing side by side and shooting. But in finals, you only have 8, maximum 10 slots for which you're shooting. So that way, you can't have 8 pairs of shooters going for the final at once. So that is where they've kind of broken it down into, let's say, qualification part one, qualification part two, and then a gold and a bronze medal match. That's how it works.
And
also for this also, they've tried and tested quite a lot of times previously, finally zeroing up on this format.
So in fact, for people who might remember, initially World Championship or Delhi, mein, they used to have only 5 teams go to the final. So 5 teams into 2, that gives you 10 slots in the final hall, which sort of can be accommodated, but they decided it was not worth it. 10 ko bhi thoda squeeze in karna padta hai, and then only 5 going to the final is not really that good. So this current is fine. And It's My Life is asking, do you like the new format? Achha, theek hai, ye toh elimination technique, right? Yeah, It's My Life, I prefer the elimination ideas. It definitely makes it much more interesting. But if you're talking about the mixed team format, I think I like this mixed team format on the whole. My only complaint is that qualification too needs to be broadcasted. Wo find a way to do that. Then I'm happy with this format. That is the only problem. And another question is there from Vignesh as to why did ISSF replace earlier individual events with the mixed event and did not add them separately? Vignesh, the reason is gender inequality. IOC is very big on gender inequality now. And shooting mein, there was a situation where you had 3 events for men and 2 events for women, which doesn't conform to gender equality. So gender equality ke liye, they had to drop a men's event and replace it with a mixed event. And uske alawa,
couple of events they had to drop, no?
Basically, har mein ek kiya, right? Ek rifle event drop kiya, ek pistol drop kiya, ek shotgun drop
kiya. Ek pistol drop kiya,
so tino categories mein se ek ek event drop karke, they added a mixed team event. And Debashish is saying team chemistry should not be touched upon in 11th hour. I mean, Debashish, I really doubt on what team chemistry means in shooting events. Eventually, both of them are shooting separately only. There is, theek hai, their scores get added up and they shoot next to each other, but they are both just doing their own thing. And I think their aim would be ke jaise main individual mein shoot karta hun, main waise hi team mein bhi shoot karun, utna hi achha hona chahiye. So, yeah, I don't think the team chemistry matters much. So that's all about the format. And in terms of results, I've put this graphic because I could not fit this in the Excel slide. So the graphic maine side mein dal rakha, if you see, there are 4 golds here for India. So 2019, we have dominated. China took the first 2 and then it's all India. And abhi Ozjek mein hangi. So this is also why, I was high on Divyansh. I think one of them is Deepak, 3 of them are Divyansh. And Apurvi and Anjum has sort of split. Maybe 3 Anjum hogi. So I'm not too sure about the breakup.
Even the second team has done fairly well.
See,
silver and a bronze and a couple of finals.
Yeah, silver, yahan pe final, everywhere. So, you think ke Ozjek ke baad you might feel ke itna bada event nahi hai, but yeah, I have huge hopes from this event. And
of course.
And Ela and Divyansh, if they can, even perform to let's say 90-95% of their potential, both of them, this is a very strong event. And India has also in general done very well in the finals. Wo bhi ek factor hai. So I think I'll just sort this by the finals ek bar. So because qualification mein you can clearly see China, Russia, India and Hungary. Aur koi hai nahi. Of course, anybody can come in the Olympics, but China, Russia, India are the teams, and there's one team from Hungary whom you have to focus on.
Strong contenders, yeah, in teams ke alawa.
Yep. And final mein agar hum dekhenge to, whatever that means.
So it's very strange to see there's no Germany and other European countries. Because Germany, you would perceive that considering their rifle pedigree, the men, women, dono hi strong honge.
Kya hua? Wait a second. Data sort. Okay.
What are we on to here, Kapil?
Yeah, I'm just sorting it by the final scores. Yeah. Yeah, so this is based on the final scores. So, final scores mein Penny and Mizaros, who's actually taken 28 shots. So, that means, I think that's like... two finals. So they have shot two finals and they have the highest overall combined average in the final, 10.459. And then you have Ilavanil and Divyansh. And finals mein thode aate hain. You know, there's Lukas Koznicki and Caroline Tucker, who maybe, you know, is a little underrated here. They have also, you know, by the way, the number of shots show how many shots they have shot in the final. So what that average is based on. So if you see, you know, 11, 13, 15, all those are like one finals. You see something like 28, 30, that's two finals. So they have shot over two finals and okay, finals mein, final mein match mein eventually kuch bhi hota hai, right? It's all about one shot, but score-wise, they are great. And another thing, you know, if you notice here, generally, a lot of the time, the woman has been shooting better than the men in rifle.
Mm.
So Ilavanil ka,
that's been the case in individual as well.
हाँ राइफल में ये केस है, पिस्टल में जनरली नहीं होता है, बट राइफल में ये है कि यू नो इवन द वुमेन कैन शूट हायर देन द मेन, सो बोथ आर लाइक कंपेरेबल. ऐसा नहीं है कि यू नो द मेन इज मच बेटर. इनफैक्ट आई हैव हर्ड, यू नो टेक्निकली मैंने सुना है, आई एम नॉट टू श्योर, कि पिस्टल में होता क्या है कि बिकॉज यू हैव टू शूट विद वन हैंड, राइट? सो यू हैव टू कीप योर हैंड लाइक दिस. सो इफ यू कैन सी, यू हैव टू कीप योर हैंड लाइक दिस, एंड ऐसे हाथ रखने में ना यू नीड सम अपर बॉडी स्ट्रेंथ टू कीप दिस हैंड स्टेडी. So, jiske wajah se, you know, the males have a little bit of an advantage over females in pistol. Lekin rifle mein, you know, your rifle is very stable. You are using both your hands and, you know, you are using your body as well to stabilize the rifle. So, uske wajah se, rifle mein, it's not much. Lakshya is asking about the...
physical aspect only, explain it.
Yeah, Lakshya is asking about the Koreans, which is a good question. Do we have Koreans here?
Actually, could be a possibility that Koreans might not have participated in a lot of mixed rifle team events also. Because if you'll see, they've been changing their squads every World Cup. So it's not like that consistent few Korean shooters have been entering the World Cups.
I think Koreans, matlab, thoda, I think male side mein maybe they are slightly weak. But yeah, they have their two quotas. It's decent. I've just put the Korea on the screen. So, you know, if you look at by the qualification rank, it's like 19th, which is fine. Yeah, they can come in. But China, India, Hungary and Russia, those are the undoubted best one. And if you just look at the medals may be sab jagah wahi hai. China, India, Hungary, Russia. Gold, silver and bronze, teen category dekho, sirf China, India, Russia, Korea hi dikhta hai. There's like one Romania, there's like one Korea. And, you know, and Romania is not going, by the way, because 10-meter air rifle may qualify nahi hue. So, this is a... I will be very disappointed if we return without a medal here.
That would be a disappointment, for sure.
Yeah, I would be very disappointed. And, iske alawa, you want to compare the finals with average? Qualification or medal match ka average, dekhoge, qualification again, as usual, thoda high hai, nothing special there. What do you expect? The only thing to note here is that women in general have a little more higher than the men. Anything else? More Vaibhav? Aur kuch dikh raha hai? Apurvi Chandela is another one. Jiska actually, you know, average here is pretty high. So if we go by the women ka average, 10.475, that's actually a very high average among the women. And the reason this average is so high is because 21 mein she didn't shoot the mixed. Ila and Anjum shot. So her average is basically based on the 2019. That's why she has five events. Five events mein, uske wajah se her average is pretty high. But she won't be shooting the mixed. It's open, but I doubt it. They'll change. बहुत बड़ा problem हो जाएगा वहाँ पे.
Yeah. There might be a lot of changes. We'll have to see. मतलब थोड़ा depend करेगा ना कि किस form के साथ कौन सा shooter आ रहा है उसी हिसाब से.
नहीं, I'm saying other countries
if,
might change.
If that option is there for the.
हाँ, I'm saying other countries might change. लेकिन आई थिंक इंडिया के लिए चेंज करना मुश्किल है बिकॉज यू नो इट्स वेरी हेविली डिक्लेयर्ड. इट्स डिक्लेयर्ड एंड यू नो इट वॉज इट वेंट थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ व्हाट डू यू से लॉट ऑफ थॉट.
ठीक है, इट्स आई मीन व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय हेविली डिक्लेयर्ड. थोड़ा सा वो हाइप इज गेटिंग क्रिएटेड बाय पीपल ऑन ट्विटर, राइट, हु कीप ऑन.
नहीं, heavily declared मतलब
it's like every country announces through a press release that this is going to be their mixed pair. So in a similar manner we also do.
नहीं, but जैसे अब if you look at China,
यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा hype create हो जाती है बस.
हाँ, लेकिन जैसे अब if you look at China, I've just put the China team on top. I don't know if वहाँ पे कहीं और declare किया, but at least this is what I found from an article. And if you look at rifle mixed team and pistol mixed team, they have just declared the four names. Which is the same as they are the individual rifles. So Yang, Qian, Wang Lua, यहाँ पे है, and women's did they change it? Oh, in fact, okay, China ने भी ऐसा किया. I didn't notice this. तुझे दिख रहा है? So Zhang Yu, for example, is in the mixed rifle team, but she's not there in the women rifle. And Yang Qian दोनों में है.
इसका इसकी एक possibility हो सकती है. If you remember the qualification rules. So China did win a quota. They did win a quota through the mixed pair also. And mixed pair का quota is by name, if I'm not wrong.
No, ऐसा नहीं है. Yeah, I have checked that. उसमें qualification का कोई issue नहीं है. They have, in fact, they have two quotas in every event except for the trap. I think men trap या नहीं, sorry, except for men's kit, जिसमें we have two quotas. So I think except for men's kit and maybe एक women's kit में भी शायद. But yeah, except for shotgun, they have two quotas everywhere. So they can send whatever they want.
So you're saying that mixed pair quota that they've won, that's not by the name and again by the NOC only.
Yeah, and it has also got reallocated. So mixed team ka maine quota dekha. Russia and China won the mixed team quotas, both rifle mein and pistol mein. And they qualified the individuals. So those quotas have got reallocated. And they get reallocated to, you know, smaller countries which have not qualified a single shooter. That way. So, वो सारे quotas reallocate हो चुके हैं. But yeah, they have also actually gone, you know, sort of the India way, where Zhang Yu is competing in air rifle mixed team, but not in women's 10 meter rifle. But, I think,
so,
yeah, I think maybe,
है, मतलब,
नहीं, but I see यहाँ पे Zhang Yu,
देखना पड़ेगा,
नहीं, but हाँ, I see यहाँ पे Zhang Yu is not competing in anything else. So, मतलब, they have used that mixed team quota. Reallocate नहीं हुआ है, but it could have been reallocated. मतलब, वो requirement नहीं है कि they had to send a separate shooter. That I can guarantee. But they are probably using their mixed team quota to send Zhang Yu. Because she's shooting only there. And,
Alright. Anything else in the mixed pair?
So, China, India, Russia?
Anything that catches your eye?
China, India, Russia, और कुछ है?
Yeah.
Any predictions?
Yeah, I think yay prediction hai. Each a medal, each one medal for each of these countries.
Ek ek medal le aao ya sare khush, every happy. Yeah, one nice question by Debashish in the chat. Even Iran can be a spoil sport. I think, lekin Iran is more
yes,
of
they
a,
can be.
I think Iran is more than pistol. Iran, yahan pe kya situation hai? Let's just see. Agar milta hai, kidhar kya country?
उनके शूटर्स तो स्ट्रॉन्ग ही है ना, राइफल के भी दोनों जेंडर के ही शूटर्स काफी स्ट्रॉन्ग
मेन में है,
तो हाँ, मतलब वोंट बी दैट सरप्राइजिंग.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल तो ईरान के पास एक ही कोटा है, दैट इज द वन थिंग. 10 मीटर राइफल में एक भी कोटा मिला नहीं है ईरान को. ओनली वन 3P शूटर विल बी गोइंग हु विल आल्सो बी शूटिंग इन 10 मीटर. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द मेल साइड, नॉट द फीमेल साइड. सो या सो ईरान में पॉइंट वही है, मेल शूटर्स आर मे बी नॉट एज स्ट्रॉन्ग. So they can all obviously create an upset, but it will be an upset. Female shooters are there, male shooters not there. Ha, USA mein there was one team, Caroline Tucker and was the other one, and Kozniski. But Kozniski, you know, it's a name we hear more about in 3P. 10 meters mein itna record acha nahi hai. So, yeah.
But Iran mein bhi this Poria Norusian, he keeps on cropping up very often. No,
didn't get the quota.
Maybe not recently, and he hasn't done well, but I think he should be in the mix if he's the one we are talking about.
मुझे जितना याद है, even Rio में he had won like the last quota Asian Championship में करके. So it's a name you hear, but I don't think it's very prominent. It's very up and down.
Not prominent, but yeah, he's a good shooter. And that Rio quota you're talking about, wo bhi kafi close tha. If you remember, I was also there in the stand. Wo Akhil Shivaran ne last shoot pe hi wo final kiya tha ki uska thoda kam chala gaya tha.
So meri samajh mein, you know, we were both there. We were wanting Akhil to get the quota. Isliye you remember. But otherwise, you know, name wise, itna it's not that big a name. And in fact, I'm just checking ki Iran bhej kisko raha hai. He's not going. Iran is saying Mayar Sedagat. Mayar Sedagat won the quota in 50 meters and he's the only male rifle shooter going. So, jo ye second name hai, Sedagat Mayar, he's the only one going. Poria Norusian is not even going.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I think.
All right.
Yeah. That's about mixed team. So, that's our 10 meter rifle, guys. I will just conclude saying that 10 meter rifle was the one category where I was disappointed in the Osijek World Cup, the Croatia World Cup. Uske lava the others we can talk as we go on, but this was the one section where I was a little disappointed because I expected more from Divyansh and Neela, and I'm still expecting more from them in Tokyo. Apurvi also, if she comes back to her form, there's nothing to stop her. Deepak will always be a little, you know, dark horse only at max, but we do have hopes here. It's not as strong in 2019 our rifle team, but hopefully they can come up with at least one medal, maybe two.
Yeah.
ठीक है तो आज rifle का बहुत बात कर लिया
Kapil, I think let's wrap it up here only. बाकी के events will take it sometime else, right?
अच्छा बाकी के 25.
क्योंकि अभी if we start talking about 25 meter pistol, so like again that's one of the hot event for us and we should be talking that in detail, right? So itni jaldi khatam ho nahi paye.
ठीक है ना? That's fine. You want to
so उसको भी आगे ले लेते हैं कभी.
You want to go through your slides a little bit के वो भी आगे के लिए रखेंगे because yeah I know
let's keep that in the end only because that would make sense in the end.
ठीक है. So guys, we have gone to us.
है ना?
Yeah, that's fine. So we have gone to us. We went in depth and teen event ho paya aaj. We'll obviously try to do another stream sometime next week. And baki side ki baatein ho gayi hai, toh we'll focus more on the events. And we'll go that way.
Yeah.
Any conclusion?
And sometime towards the night, midweek, right? Does that suit you?
Yeah, yeah.
Agar beach mein kare.
आउटपुट बढ़ाओ एक हफ्ते में एक बहुत कम है तो दिस इज द टाइम एंड आई थिंक शूटिंग डिजर्व्स दैट आउटपुट राइट. Shooting is the critical event in for India, at least in my opinion, because I think India ka medals tally will be directed a lot by shooting. Without shooting, we might get like maybe 3 medals. Agar achha hua to okay, we can get more. But shooting is the one which can, you know, really push you to like close to double digits, if not in double digits. So, and it is also happens in the beginning. Lot of people, you know, say ki shuru mein agar medal aa jata hai na, to the pressure reduces a lot. Otherwise, वो प्रेशर बढ़ता रहता है इंडिया का एक भी मेडल नहीं आया इंडिया का एक भी मेडल नहीं आया मीरा भाई इज ऑल्सो देयर टू विन अ मेडल ऑन द फर्स्ट डे बट
थोड़ा सा वो मेरे को ज्यादा ओवर हाइप भी लगता है बिकॉज़ ऑफ रियो की पिछली बार ऐसा वो प्रेशर सॉर्ट ऑफ क्रिएट हो गया था बट आई ऑलवेज गो बैक टू द एशियन गेम्स इफ यू रिमेंबर एशियन गेम्स में वी स्टार्टेड ऑफ दिल्ली वेल पहले दिन विनेश बूम गोल्ड मेडल बजरंग बूम गोल्ड मेडल बट हाउ डिड वी एंड अप एशियन गेम्स वी एंडेड अप being disappointed again, right? So how much did that reflect on the entire mood of contingent? So it's again subjective and debatable. Thoda sa keh sakte hain hamare context mein because we are always starving for the medals, so that does might change the mood. बट इतना ज्यादा होना नहीं चाहिए जितना लाइक लोग बातें करते।
ठीक है गाइस, सो सी यू ड्यूरिंग द वीक। आई होप यू गाइस विल जॉइन अस ड्यूरिंग द वीक एज वेल दिस टाइम, एंड वी विल डू अ पार्ट टू ऑफ दिस। एंड जाने के पहले डू लाइक द स्ट्रीम इफ यू हैव नॉट डन सो, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू लाइक द स्ट्रीम गाइस,
एज वेल एज सब्सक्राइब गाइस।
जिसने भी सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया कर दो। आई कैन सी, ठीक है, देयर आर अबाउट 40 पीपल वॉचिंग, 40 लाइक्स। सो जिसने भी लाइक नहीं किया है, बिकॉज सम पीपल हु हैव गॉन वुड हैव आल्सो लाइक्ड, तो जिसने भी लाइक नहीं किया है जाने के पहले प्लीज लाइक करके जाना। And give us feedback.
And do let us know in the comments, Twitter feedback. Yeah, exactly.
And everybody knows our Twitter handles. I think most of us here follow us on Twitter. If nobody does, then do that as well. And okay, we'll see you during the week, guys. Bye bye.
Yes, see you soon. Bye bye. Enjoy
week, the rest of your Sunday, guys.
Yeah.
Okay. So.
All right. Bye bye.
And stream.